fucking back.
We're back. We're back, and hopefully you can hear
Before
us.
Before the show, Isla was like, don't pound on the desk. And then I was like, I guarantee you we're going to pound on the desk. Well, first thing Hubert does.
Just, you can pound on the desk now. Just don't pound your mic on the desk.
Okay. I'll protect the mic.
If you take your mic off, don't slam it on the desk.
It's just a comedy. It's just a comedy.
Elden Ring!
Elden Ring!
Boy, now Elden that Ring. Seed's been planted, right?
Right on the top.
Elden Ring waiting room.
Yeah, little update. We're all stoked for Elden Ring, despite our best judgment, and the AC is broken again.
What? That's why it's so hot.
Yes, the AC is not working again. It was fixed 2 days ago.
All right.
Oh, no.
Thanks, everybody, for tuning in.
Yep.
I'm bringing my portable one. This is what the studio looks like.
Next time.
We're going home.
I'm bringing this tower. I got a tower that's like this tall. I'm bringing it in. Just blast us. Just
blow air on the mics all day. Yeah. No, I text them again. Hopefully they'll fix it.
So Elden Ring, we should definitely open the conversation with this.
Yes.
100%.
We've been talking about Scholar of the First Sin and Dark Souls 3 for about 35 minutes.
The rumors are at an all-time high because of Jeff Keighley himself. Jeff Keighley was put in gamer prison last year when he didn't reveal Elden Ring. You know, someone memed like him in prison or whatever. Days ago, he tweets something along the lines of like a baby crawling out of a crib or something, like crawling out of prison.
Gamer
bars.
Prison?
Yes.
Yo,
gamer prison.
I choose to believe that Keighley busted ass to get this reveal because he wanted out of prison.
Yes.
Like, we not put him in gamer prison, today would not happen.
If he does it, he'll be a hero to the people.
Yeah, he'll be a
hero. He wants to be the people's champion.
He wants to be the people's champion.
He wants nothing more than to be loved by everyone.
Yes.
Yeah, I feel like it opens or closes the show for real. Like, not even a pipe dream, not exaggerating. I would... Maybe I've said that a bunch of times. I feel like we all have. I'd be shocked if Elden Ring didn't show up for this.
Is it too powerful to open the show, though? It's like, it opens the show and then everyone just goes to sleep because they pass out.
That's it always gets weird when you realize, like, you get on these things and you've been saying the same thing for years.
I know!
For four years!
Yeah, like, I can't wait to see Elden Ring. I can't wait to see Bayonetta 3. And it's like, wow, I've spent, like, a not insignificant chunk of my life saying that things.
Metroid 4 is going to be here. Breath of the Wild 2 is going to be here. Starfield's going to be here. It's all going to be here.
Yeah, since Sony doesn't have their own thing that we know of yet, I feel like this is a great opportunity for some Sony games to show up.
Yeah.
Mainly we know Last of Us multiplayer is in the works. Factions. Mm-hmm. I'm still holding out hope that that shows up. I feel like that could be a safe bet for this.
Yeah, that's a good call.
What do you think, Ben? Factions.
What is exciting about this show in particular, right, is this year with E3, like, everything is very targeted. So it's like, okay, we can kind of expect these things at this show. We can kind of expect these things at this show. Yeah. This Summer Game Fest, man, I don't know what the hell is going to happen.
Yeah.
It's a J.J. Abrams mystery box.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Except for Elden Ring.
Yeah. We know. Yeah, yeah. So and the ending has been planned out already.
you're saying Emperor Palpatine is going to
come back for some reason?
The dead speak.
Mm-hmm.
Somehow, Palpatine returned, and his name was Elden Ring.
Like, Hubert, I think if you leaned into anything, you could probably get me nodding my head and being like, yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, sure.
Do you think there'll be Last of Us DLC?
They said no a while ago.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure they said like they had no real plans for that. I feel like they're all in just on the multiplayer.
Yeah.
I feel like until,
it's gonna be big.
Yeah, until that is revealed and released and stuff, I think that's
okay,
where all their focus is.
That makes sense. No Capcom here because they have their own show, so we should not expect Village or anything.
Will there be any double dipping, though?
Well,
Capcom shows up and they're like, hey, stay tuned for more of this, you know, at our own show, but here's a little tease.
Double dip offenders are things like Battlefield.
Yes.
Yes.
Call of Duty.
Yep.
You know,
that's
your
triple dip.
Your racing games.
Battlefield is triple dip.
Triple dip.
Yeah.
Same trailer in multiple pressers.
If you could see a cast member from Fast and Furious presenting it, those are your double dip offenders
for sure.
Yes.
Oh my God. Arc 2, dude.
Oh,
it's going to be in everything.
They're gonna
feel
the rocks in it.
It feels important.
You know
it's gonna be here.
You know Vin Diesel is gonna show up in this. Jeff loves
Vin
Diesel.
Yeah. Can't wait.
Oh my God. Kojima and Vin Diesel will kiss.
Yeah, Kojima.
Kojima at this show. A possibility here. Long history of Jeff Keighley.
For whatever reason, my mind always goes to a Death Stranding director's cut. Is that a thing?
I don't know. The game is already a director's cut. Like, what?
What else is there to put in that game?
I could see Kojima, like, as an experiment, like, doing an undirector's cut where he, like, hired a studio to come in and, like, ruin his game for him.
Redux.
Yeah, ruin Death Stranding for him. Threw it in reverse.
I could see, like, some sort of weird, cryptic Kojima teaser that has no title or anything or makes any sense.
Just the space whale again.
Yeah, you know there'll be a whale in it.
That's a classic Game Awards thing with Kojima. It's just the wildest absolute trailer.
Yeah, just like, what the hell?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Looking at. Brad, what do you want to see here, dude? Summer Game Fest.
Oh, I mean, Elden Ring's my number one.
Of course.
I still think about that rumor of the Switch Pro being revealed before E3.
Oh my God.
But at this point, I'm just like, we're so close to their own press conference. I don't think they would do it, would they? At this thing?
Unless, that would be wild.
The only reason
Did you mean the Super Switch?
Yeah, the Super Switch. The Super Switch Pro.
The Switch Professional?
Yeah. Professional. If they write it out, that would be
the
only reason I could see them doing it today is if they, like, if pre-orders open on Tuesday or some crazy shit like that. Like, but otherwise, no. Like, yeah, that's...
I don't think it's likely. Dark horse here, but if the NetherRealm, if the rumored NetherRealm Marvel game showed up, definitely a big
CG
deal.
CG trailer here.
Yep.
More at their own event.
Yep.
What are the rumors?
I like it.
That they're making a Marvel fighting game? Or?
Yes, and then Ed Boon came out on Twitter and, like, winked as hard as someone could wink without actually saying it. So,
yeah, he said something that was like, it was like almost just saying
it. It was almost just saying it. Correct.
Because then there's another rumor that Firaxis is making a...
Firaxis is
making a Marvel one. Yeah.
Dude, Marvel XCOM. Yeah. Sign me up.
Oh, like an XCOM?
Yeah, XCOM but with Marvel is the rumor.
Dude, that'd be sick.
XCOM Marvel permadeath. Like, Spider-Man's dead, bro.
Spider-Man's dead.
You fucked up. Spider-Man's dead.
The most...
Wolverine somehow is dead.
I can already see them tweeting it out. The graphic of, like, 93% of players are save scummers.
Yeah.
It's like, I'm not letting Spider-Man die.
Yeah.
That'd be really
I wonder
funny,
if
actually.
Fraxis would embrace, like, the Desperados thing and just be like, hey, save scum, please. Yeah. Like, we know you love Jubilee.
I love that. Right at the top.
Jubilee is on my squad for sure. Jubilee, why don't you shoot some fireworks?
Yeah. Jubilee and Dazzler only.
Yep. Dazzler only.
Yo, but Nightcrawler would be OP, man.
Nightcrawler would be
teleport behind the enemy.
Yeah.
You know that they would limit his range.
Dude. And like, you know I would teleport into danger and die.
Yeah.
Oh,
it wouldn't
sure.
be OP for
you. Got to play as Colossus. Then you'll be okay.
High mobility, but he's weak when he's left alone.
What about,
you got one more of those.
What about some smaller stuff, indie stuff, something like Shredder's Revenge? I just wanted to drop that name.
That
in
sounds
here.
Nice.
Something like Streets of Rage 4 DLC that we know about.
I think Shredder's Revenge... Definite possibility.
Dude, yes.
Yeah, I think we're I really think so. It's a perfect thing for a Summer Game Fest. I could see it.
Did
Dead to Rights into Shredder's Revenge.
Yes!
Dead to Rights!
Did Silksong say they're not coming?
Yeah,
they're
right.
Not.
Yeah,
no Silksong.
My God.
Hold fast, everyone. Hold fast.
At this point, I just expect
coming.
Team Cherry to come out and say, lol, there is no game.
Yeah, didn't you play it like 3 years
yeah,
ago?
Yeah, I did. I played it. I played the game.
And it was already looking good.
Yeah, no, it was done. Yeah. It was in a shippable state. Like
shippable state.
What the hell? Whatever, let it cook.
Yeah, it's cooking.
Let it cook, baby. Let it cook.
Dude, it's burning. It's burning. That's what's happening.
It's part of the recipe.
Yeah,
it is congealed to the bottom of the pan. Oh my God.
Yes. Isla, what would you like to see at the Summer Game Fest? Obviously, Elden Ring.
Obviously, Elden Ring.
Obviously.
Honestly, Keighley, like, he always surprises and slightly disappoints. So that's what I'm expecting, you know? I'm always ready to feel hyped in the moment and then rethink it later and be like, yeah, it was okay.
That's
So I think that is the best summation I've heard of these things.
Like, they're going to drop, like, six bombs, yeah. But no Elden Ring.
But no Elden Ring. And I'll just, that's all I'll remember. Wait. Is the stain.
Talos Principle 2.
Oh my god, Brad. It's
and
time,
maybe
dude.
Outer Wilds DLC.
Brad, you know me
made
better
the show.
Than...
Made the show for Isla.
Yes.
There it is.
I forget shit when people ask
it?
Me what I like.
Disco
I like
Elysium
the Outer Wilds
2.
DLC
Disco
leak
Elysium
on Steam
2.
Or something? Is that what it was?
What did you say?
Did the Outer Wilds DLC leak on Steam or something?
They, it seemed like it might have been intentional. They like put a thing on Steam and then like
cheeky.
Someone tweeted it, but it might
cheeky.
Have been them.
Cheeky.
Like they're like, hey, something just got added to Steam, and then Annapurna like, you know, embraced it.
Summer Game Fest, Keeley, big budget blockbusters. Where is Star Wars at this point? Is
Star Wars?
Yeah.
It's at EA Play.
Yeah,
two
yeah Galaxy
or
Far, Far
and
Away.
Any kind of Star Wars thing is going on. Brad Ellis.
I mean, there's Star Wars games being made that aren't EA, but the only thing I could see is maybe that Fallen Order remaster, whatever they're doing this summer or something like that. I know they kind of remastered already, but something else with it.
Nice.
Because they're making a sequel, 100%.
Yeah.
100%, but yeah. That would probably be at EA.
Star Wars, I feel like, is a little bit tricky to predict because you'll get, like, an EA mode of, like, here's Squadrons.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right.
So... Who knows?
Has Fallen Order had a PS5 patch?
There was a patch, yeah.
There was a patch. Okay. There's no DLC.
No.
I just remember that moment.
Or, like, major story
when they
DLC.
Announced Star Wars, like, Fallen Order, kind of. I remember in the crowd, like, Andrea was in the crowd.
Yeah.
Was that Game Awards, I think?
Yeah.
It was a Keeley
thing. It was a
Keeley
thing, yeah.
It was weird.
It was weird.
And then
it
he was
weird.
Like, yeah, it's called Jedi Fallen Order. And everyone was like,
what?
Oh, thanks for telling us.
That doesn't mean anything.
Boy... The reveal for that game underwhelmed me so completely. I'm surprised I ended up loving that game as much as I did.
When you played it, and you're like, oh,
yeah.
Now I get it.
Yep.
The reveal of that title definitely made like your Metroid Prime 4 trailer seem a little more impactful, a little more special.
Speaking of Metroid,
it's not going to be
here.
Till
next
week. Nintendo's not till next week, but can we expect anything Nintendo in the Summer Game Fest?
Given his relationship with Reggie,
Nintendo?
I know he's not there anymore, but like, maybe he has an ongoing relationship with Bowser. Who knows?
Nintendo likes to just tickle Jeff Keighley a little bit.
Yeah,
just a little little tickle,
just a little. Here's a Bayonetta 3 tease, and
we'll
see you next week.
It's
but
weird
not
though.
Be there, right?
I don't see them showing up really because they've got their thing in like 4 days.
Yeah.
Although. I don't know. You think about strategy, right? Mind share.
Yeah.
Okay. You come out swinging with a Breath of the Wild 2 tease or a Metroid tease or Bayonetta tease or whatever. Then people are just talking about Nintendo until the Nintendo event.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You just throw a blanket over everybody else.
They Love could it. Start and end E3.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which
yeah.
would
Honestly.
Be pretty hype.
All you need is just key art of Breath of the Wild 2. Just a picture. They've done shit like that in the past in Nintendo. They're like, here's their concept art. That's about it.
Jeff Keighley just
lose
wearing
their mind.
A Breath of the Wild 2 like pin.
Oh, yeah. I love the pins.
The pins is
the
good.
The pin shade
yeah.
is so
we'll
good.
Will make everyone go insane.
Yeah.
Oh.
It's really good. How much time we got?
10 minutes. T-minus.
I wonder if...
10 minutes.
Like, we'll see Diablo 2 Resurrected here or anything like that.
Oh, that's a good call.
No BlizzCon. Yeah. So, Blizzard... Brad, I wasn't even thinking about that. Blizzard could definitely have a presence at this.
Yeah.
Maybe 4 or 2.
Maybe 4, yeah.
Look.
Just a CG or something.
I would be thrilled to see anything Diablo, but if they show up Diablo 2 Resurrected, I want them to be honest. I want them to say, listen, no one's excited about our current stuff, so here's a game from 20 years ago that's really good. That's the kind of messaging that I want from Blizzard at this point.
Hey, do you remember when you loved us?
Hey, do you remember?
So do we.
So do we.
Love us again.
Our bank accountants remember. I don't know why I said bank accountants.
Bank accountants.
Final Fantasy.
Ooh.
Oh. Hold up.
Just came out.
Right.
Intergrade.
Intergrade. Mm. Downloading on my PS5 right now.
Could see Intergrade
I
here.
I could see Intergrade here. Some kind of
Not
trailer or commercial
here,
in between. Like
Ooh,
some of those
dude,
ads.
I hope
they're
just like Dirge of Cerberus 2.
Oh my god. Shadow drop.
Well, Shadow drop.
And
yeah.
I know Square Enix has their own thing, uh-huh. but Final Fantasy in general. can we expect anything Final Fantasy related here?
Well, the thing about Final Fantasy is, like, Final Fantasy is such a huge umbrella, right? Right? Yeah. Could be anything.
Yeah.
Could be, you know, you're 16 at one end and you're first soldier on the other, right? Right. Like, there's a lot of ground to cover there. Rumored Souls game from Team Ninja.
Mm-hmm.
That would be incredible. I mean, that that might even steal the show.
Advent Children commercial. Up. That's what they're going to do for the 4K that just came out.
Nice. Nice.
Damiani, I come in this morning. Damiani, been here forever, since like 2 or something, has a 4K Blu-ray of Advent Children just sitting on the desk next to the switching board.
Hell yeah.
I'm like, yeah, that makes sense. I don't even need an explanation for this.
He's been up all night.
Love it.
Damiani.
Dedication, working. Dude. Love Damiani it. In there in the switching board.
Yep.
Doing great.
Making the magic happen.
Making the magic happen.
Give us some switches, Damiani. Reveal yourself.
Oh, we're revealing the 4K right now, baby.
He's showing,
yes!
He's showing the Advent
Children. 4K!
There it is, dude.
Yeah, there it
I
is.
I will trade you a 4K copy of Advent Children to fix the AC.
Dripping already.
Dude, just wait. Dude, I was in here for 4 hours for that AMA.
Dripping.
It's gonna get worse, and I was in here alone.
We haven't talked about this. I don't think I've talked about this with any of y'all, but... Yeah. I would be really excited to see anything on Skate 4.
Ooh, Skate 4.
And Skate Bird.
Less excited for Skate Bird.
All the extreme sports games need to show up.
I was way into Skate Bird, and then I played it, and I was like, oh.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was rough.
Well, yeah,
it's
early access, I think. Yeah.
Let it cook.
Could be maybe a new Tony Hawk game.
Yeah, I was thinking that, too.
Could
I was actually going to say that, and my mind went to.
Could do 3 and 4, yeah. But isn't that team? I think that team's working on Diablo 2 now. So I don't know.
That's true. Got it. Man, we're gonna get DMCA'd so hard if there's a Tony Hawk 3 4 remaster.
Toast.
There's is that for this one though? There's
no, that's Square Enix or whatever. I think was
the alt stream.
The alt stream, yeah. The same.
I think a new Tony something regarding the Tony Hawk game.
Downhill Jam 3.
Yeah, it'll happen.
Will Tony Hawk be here?
I would not.
I could see that.
Yeah, I would not be surprised.
Dude just kind of shows up sometimes.
Hey, Jeff.
Damn it! Why did we not have a Tony Hawk bet?
But no one recognizes him.
Dude,
ever.
Yep. He's over 50, still rocking,
crushing
Looks
it
great.
Out there.
Yeah,
still shredding.
Yeah, still shredding. Absolutely.
What did he do? He just did like a 720 or something.
I think it was a 9, whatever. Yeah.
50 years old.
Pretty
professional.
Good
job, Tony.
6 minutes.
6 minutes.
We could just talk about Scholar of the First Sin again.
And Elden Ring. Honestly, I'm expecting, no joke, this is not a troll, 100% I'm expecting George R.R. Martin to
come
reveal
out.
Himself.
I'm
not kidding.
I would honestly not be surprised. Oh,
hey,
yeah, we got
hey, Jeff.
Turn off all that overlay.
Do you guys ever feel like your life just kind of amounts to waiting for the next Souls game? You know what I mean?
Yes.
Like every day.
Yeah.
Just the next Souls game and the next Silent
The next Resident
Evil.
Oh,
it's a vicious cycle.
We broke the seal. We broke the seal.
We said it. I said it. Could it be here? Could it exist?
There's been so many rumors putting Silent Hill on Xbox.
Yeah.
Like Microsoft Silent Hill.
What? Where are you reading these rumors?
The rumor, well, it was Kojima. The whole it all stemmed from Kojima. Doing a Microsoft exclusive, and then that got muddied into Kojima Silent Hill exclusive on Xbox, I think.
I'm going to need
something.
To see the sources
all just
on
rumors,
this.
Rumors.
Guillermo, hitting the stage
if I have no expectations for Silent Hill being here, but if it was, like, E3 would already be made for me.
Oh, yeah.
Like, mm-hmm. In the bag.
Yeah.
I think
open
it's more
with
likely...
Elden Ring, close with Silent Hill.
Can you imagine greatest E3 presentation of all time?
If Silent Hill gets announced, Blood, I need you to get on those codes immediately.
Yeah.
But like you said earlier, just this E3 is so different because last year was so weird and you know,
yeah,
crazy.
You know what it is?
Now it can just be anything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
You realize that you kind of, like, E3's hype every year, right? We get excited for E3 every year. But this year made me realize that we kind of take that excitement for granted.
Yes.
There is a hunger now that we've had a year off. Like, dude, it's like rabid dog hunter.
Yeah, starving.
Starving.
We were saying before the show, it's like, if you show me, you know, a JPEG of Elden Ring, like, I'm into that.
Yeah. I'm into it.
I'll take it.
Show me the HUD.
Show me the HUD. Show me the options menu.
Starving.
Absolutely starving.
Yeah, what if it is just like going through the menu system of Elden Ring? I'd be like, yes.
Any candidates for shadow drops or betas?
Always something.
Yeah, I'm sure he'll have one or two. Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah. Keeley's actually literally said shadow drop on a stage, mm-hmm. so...
Yeah, we know that there's going to be about 12 world premieres. Those are yep. unannounced games and updates to existing games. Keeley has been just fanning the Elden Ring flames. That's why
he knows what he's doing.
Not stop talking about it until the show is over, minimum.
it's funny though because like he could think he's fanning the flames of like
I know.
Something else entirely, but we're just reading it as Elden Ring, you know?
We see what we want to see.
We absolutely see what
we see
do.
What we want to see. Yeah. He's fanning the flames of, like, some innocuous DLC, and we're just like, Elden Ring!
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Ratchet & Clank's coming out soon. I imagine that'll show up maybe in some capacity.
Yeah. Oh, some small thing. Yeah.
I mean, I think you hit the nail on the head with, like, interstitial ads.
Yeah.
Like, I think Integrated was the perfect call for that.
Yeah.
Of course, with this kind of stuff, it's hard to tell anymore, mm-hmm. like what's been sponsored and what's not. But
trying to think of anything else. Anything we leave on the table? Anything good in chat, Isla?
I'm looking.
I think some of the least exciting stuff. Anytime somebody says like, here's the exclusive reveal on like the next Call of Duty season. Like that's. That's
season,
a low point on the show,
yeah.
for sure.
Yeah, yeah. I want to see.
Yeah.
See, yeah. Fortnite, fortunately, just had their season update, so I doubt we'll be getting any updates regarding that.
Ooh.
I expect to see a Fortnite trailer, though. I expect to see some aliens and Superman flying around, mm-hmm. definitely.
People in chat are saying Dino Crisis.
Oh, God.
Whoa.
Capcom.
We're in the
Capcom. That's
we're
Capcom.
In the stratosphere now.
Capcom,
Dead
we'll
Space?
Get there.
They're saying Dead Space re-releases?
Yeah, we're
dude,
we've left orbit.
We've left orbit. Rune
give
Factory
me a
5.
Dead Space remaster. That's it. You want to talk about starving? I'll just take a remaster. It doesn't even need to be a trilogy, Brad. Dead Space 1 remaster.
1080p, 30fps.
Yeah, like bare bones. I'll take it. Please.
Chat also points out, Ben, you're wearing a jacket.
Yeah.
And it's 86 degrees.
Fashion Souls.
Look,
baby.
Fashion Souls,
baby. Yep.
It'll come
it.
Off when Elden Ring.
I play the real game.
He's not wearing it for the stats, chat. He's wearing it for the fashion.
Yeah, as soon as George R. R. Martin shows up, it's coming
jacket's
off.
Jacket's off.
Yeah. Well, that's not the only thing that's coming off.
All right, 25 seconds here, allegedly.
Huber, put your powers out there right now.
Elden Ring, seriously, every single fiber of my being believes in Elden Ring appearing now.
And he's got a lot of fibers.
100% feeling it.
Trillions of Huber fibers.
Put it out there.
Elden Ring is an elusive creature, though.
It is.
I've had this feeling before.
All right, I'm going to turn off chat in here, so they're monitoring it in the other
I just
room.
Hope the stream holds.
Yes.
May contain content that some viewers find offensive.
We made it. We made it to E3.
We made it, dude.
We made it.
The heat is making
parental advisory.
There he is.
St. Keeley.
I told you we'd start right on time. And welcome to Summer Game Fest Kickoff Live, presented by Prime Gaming. I'm Jeff Keeley, and buckle up. Because we've got a big show for you.
Buckle up!
Keeley, I like your shoes.
He's always got, kicking sneakers.
Surprises and special guests, including Jeff Goldblum, Giancarlo Esposito, and performances by Weezer, Japanese Breakfast, and the Sonic the
Japanese
Hedgehog
Breakfast?
Hasn't Game Awards, had Weezer multiple times?
He loves Weezer.
He loves Weezer.
Twists along the way today, and just wait until you see what we have planned for the end game. That is all I'm allowed to tell you right now.
Whoa, dude. Keeley knows how to hype.
Is that an Avengers
nod? He just casted a line, you know. He's reeling people in.
I am reeled.
Yeah.
He shot the hook right here.
And believe me, there is a lot of great stuff coming your way. But today, we kick things off with a big 90-minute cross-industry showcase meant to put platforms and rivalries
aside. Where'd that other
aside,
half hour go?
We will
yes.
have updates and news for you, no matter if you play on Nintendo Switch, PC, PlayStation, or Xbox. The biggest games
Sorry,
in the
Stadia.
World will be
Not
here.
Stadia, though.
Yeah, I was just thinking that.
Yeah.
Made by emerging voices and developers from around the world who represent what's next. Thank you so much for tuning in and kicking off Video Game Summer.
Let's go.
Video
Let's
Game Summer!
With a brand new game announcement.
Okay.
You're about to see
the world premiere of the next great adventure from Gearbox and 2K.
Oh.
Huh. Battleborn 2, baby.
Can you imagine?
Prepare.
Cool eyeball.
Uh-oh.
It's Buckling!
Oh, it's, this is a red herring. It's Borderlands.
You think
it
so?
It soars on the wind. It rises from the grave.
Cool.
It stalks the ocean floor. You cannot hide from fate.
Yeah, it's... I think it's Borderlands. I think Brad's right.
Make your own.
Oh my god.
Oh god.
Andy Samper. Wanda Sykes.
Whoa, what?
So it's a comedy game?
Yes.
Tiny Tina?
What, Stallion?
It's a Borderlands.
Oh my god, why is it
Wonderland!
Oh. Fantasy Borderlands!
Roll for initiative!
Yep.
Oh, so it's like a full game.
Okay.
It'll be fun.
There you go. Yeah.
It'll be fun.
That was a chill trailer. That was lighthearted.
Tiny Tina's Wonderlands is official, and joining us now is Tiny Tina herself, Ashley Burch. Hey, Ash, how you
What's
doing?
What's up, baby? How you doing?
Great to have you here. So I think the big question everyone's going to have is, what is Wonderlands? What can you tell us about it?
It's a great question. Yes. It's a high fantasy take on a looter shooter, as you saw, and if you're a fan of Borderlands, you'll probably recognize some fantasy elements inspired by Assault on Dragon Keep, which was the Borderlands 2 DLC that was beloved by the devs, and so this kind of inspired Wonderlands.
Now, I think the elephant in the room is this a Borderlands game? Is it not? How does it relate?
So it actually isn't. It's its own standalone game. And people that love Borderlands are going to find lots of elements to love about Wonderlands, but it's its own thing. Yeah. Tiny Tina's got her own thing going on now. So it's got its own mechanics. There's spell casting. You can customize your character this time, which is super exciting. Huh. And yeah, so if you love Borderlands, you're gonna find stuff to love in this. And if you've never played a Borderlands game, this is a great place to start.
Okay, well, Tiny Tina gets her own game, which is fantastic. Yes. What is her role? Why does she get her own game?
So she is your bunker master. Yeah. She is kind of guiding the narrative and changing it on a dime if she wants. And she's just taking your cast of characters, which is an amazing cast, through this wacky world, and she's taking you on an adventure to defeat the Dragon Lord. And who is that? I don't know. You'll have to play.
And I wonder who plays the Dragon Lord, because you can see the voice cast, including you in this, which is awesome. So feels like such a big experience. So this was a bit of a tease, announcing it's out there. When will we find out more about this game?
Hopefully this summer, and you can find out a lot more at playwonderlands.com if you'd like.
Okay.
But yeah, just stay tuned for updates.
All right, coming early 2022, so look forward to next year. Ash, thank you so much for joining us in person.
Thanks for having me.
I really appreciate it, and we'll see more later this summer on that game.
Oh, yeah.
All right, well, now it is time for another brand new game announcement.
He's probably in
this one you probably are not expecting. A classic 90s franchise is coming back to life as a grid-based tactical strategy title for Steam on PC. This is an insanely fun trailer. I hope you'll enjoy it.
90s, dude. Let's go.
Grid-based tactical?
Oh!
Is Metal Slug?
Yeah,
Metal Slug?
Yeah!
Oh,
yes!
Oh my god!
Where are the codes?
Where's Dawn?
Dude!
Yep.
Yes!
Yep.
Oh, that's
Hell
sick,
yeah.
Dude.
This looks so good.
Show me Field!
Release it now!
Can I watch this movie?
Yeah, dude. Oh, it looks
oh
so good!
Oh my god, dude.
So good! Love this kind of style.
The sounds are perfect.
Yeah,
one to one. There she is! Hell yeah!
Fio! Fio! Did they say the other names or just her?
I think
there's only one star.
I missed it because we were all yelling at it.
Yeah!
This is so cool.
Yeah. You know, E3 looking pretty good.
Dude.
So far.
Yeah, this is awesome. Holy shit.
I'm pretty sure it said Dot Even when it came.
Shadow drop this shit.
Oh, really? Yeah, is it weird I'm expecting a shadow drop?
Yo, Levolution.
God, these cuts.
And I threw it on the soundtrack. Dude, Metal Slug Tactics!
Yeah,
dude. Holy shit!
Dot Emo,
best in the biz right now. Wow. Yes.
Give me a date.
Okay, we have another big announcement for you.
No, go back to Metal Slug.
But it's well past 3 a.m. their time, so don't worry. We chatted earlier,
Kojima?
And I'm very excited
pre-tape
to share
Kojima?
This with you right now. Hello, mystery guest.
Yeah.
Yeah! Someone's getting paid.
Who bet on
Kojima,
that?
It
who
is so
that?
Good to see you.
Bets
for joining us.
Bets
from Tokyo. First of all, I just want to ask, how are you doing? How are you feeling? How are things right now over there in Japan?
Tokyo desu. Mata hijou jitai sengen tteiu no ga detete, ma chotto corona no kanja su ga fue tsutsu aru to. De, vakushin wo sorosoro utisatou to shiteru.
Well, we certainly hope that you're going to get your vaccine soon. Let me ask you, as a creator, how has this past year impacted you?
MGS2,
baby.
Well, I know we are all very curious about what the next era of Hideo Kojima Entertainment is going to be. I don't know how much you can say, but can you give us any sense of kind of where your mind's at right now, what you're thinking about, some of the themes or the ideas?
When I have finished
right,
deciding the future,
I tried.
You know,
honestly, I really.
When I have invented the next state of reality,
say hello to everyone.
You will live in it.
We miss you, and we can't wait to see what you're working on next. So, thank you.
Jeff. One more thing.
Director's cut. Yep, there it is.
There it is.
PS5 version.
That's DLC.
This looks new.
Yep. Yeah.
Yep. Straight up.
Going underground.
Please just have an Ape Escape monkey just show up out of nowhere.
Metal Gear.
It's Metal Gear, dude.
Shit.
Oh my god. It is.
Straight up Metal Gear music, too.
Please be top down camera.
Halo? Looks
like. Is Kojima forcibly taking back Metal Gear?
Dude.
Put the headband on, Sam.
If he's like, I'm gonna need some help for this one.
The vent!
Yeah. Snake walks out.
This is...
Box. It's a box!
Fragile Express, dude. Oh my god, do it! Do it! Oh my god!
What is going on?
Sam! Oh my god!
Is David Hayter gonna be in there?
I hope so.
He is, dude.
Yep. Metal Gear Solid 2.
Oh my god. Continuity on the backpack, but that's okay.
This box.
What are you doing, Sam?
If I fits, I sits.
Kojima has outdone himself with the trolling.
Fully insane. Oh, okay, not gonna do it.
What a troll.
Tested it out, but no thanks, he says.
Maybe it's just showing we can do it. You know?
That's where it cuts?
Director's cut!
Yeah! Yeah! What the fuck? What?
I swear I didn't have inside knowledge. Yeah.
What was the first game?
What are
the... He runs his own game. The company is named after himself.
Wow.
Everything's a director's cut.
It's just he loves movies. It seems like he would do it.
Death Stranding director's cut finally confirmed. I hope I make it into the director's cut. I'm told the full...
Oh, right, you're in the game.
Stay tuned.
Luden's fan,
right,
dude.
Next. It's my honor to welcome to Summer Game Fest.
What if that's what the director's cut is? He just added more people.
Of his Disney Plus show to exploring the world of gaming.
And
has been in games like Call of Duty Black Ops 3. And we're thrilled to have him here at Summer Game Fest. Jeff Goldblum, how are you, my friend?
Thank you so much.
Oh my God.
Ooh,
Joffrey. Sorry. I think it's Jeffrey. Hey, maybe it's Jeff. Hi, Jeff. Thank you so much, sincerely, for having me here. I'm thrilled to be here. Hey, I was watching your show, and
looking
I was
good.
Wondering
yeah, he looks cool.
If there might be some video game world premieres, as you say. And sure enough, there is. There is.
Yes, dude, we do like our world premieres around here. Any chance you brought one with you today?
Well, it's funny you should say that. Yes, you could say yes, I do. If you don't mind, I've got something here. I'm going to read it on this. There's a little bit of a teleprompter that they're putting up here, so I'm going to read something because I don't want to get it wrong. I'm very meticulous about this. So here's a dramatic reading of this game announcement. Ready? I'm going to make the game announcement right now. Hello. I'm here to welcome you to a very different world. It's going to elevate you to new heights. It's going to submerge you to new depths. Maybe even challenge you to control chaos.
Is it Jurassic Park then?
Actually, it's going to certainly challenge you to control chaos. It's a world so-called evolved.
Jurassic World Evolution
2? Take a look at the, you guessed it, world premiere.
Can he just do the whole show?
Yeah, his voice, dude. Yeah, that's a pterodactyl.
Dawn, dude.
We ignored all the warnings. We forgot the lessons. We abused our power.
That's Jurassic World.
We played with genetics like it was a toy.
We played with genetics.
Yeah. So good.
We weren't careful. And now, here we are. This is a very different world.
Yeah.
Oh, I'd be so
into that. Oh, okay, just a two. All right. Right.
The Dawn pick.
Love the idea of dinosaurs just, like, being around with humans, like, normally now.
R2, baby.
This year.
It looks like it's outside of the park. Like, it looks like you're not doing parks anymore, mm-hmm. maybe.
A world of evolved. That's a cool premise.
Hey, I like Jurassic World Evolution, man.
This performer's new album, Jubilee, is out now, and her book, Crying in H Mart, is a New York Times bestseller. Here now to perform Glider from the upcoming open-world game Sable by Raw Fury and Shedworks.
Sable?
It's Japanese Breakfast.
Oh, she's in Sable.
Do we need to remix? Are we safe?
Apparently it's clear, so we're fine.
What?
Apparently it's cleared, so we're fine.
Oh, thanks, Jeff. He thought of everything. I'm caught between
the wind and parts of the Mandalorian
tech.
To see, it feels like everything is moving. We gotta get a gold mic.
This is like the Dawn show. Dawn.
Yeah.
Sable, Jurassic Park, Jeff Goldblum.
He works on the show.
Yeah.
That's why he's not here.
Jeff consulted. Yeah, he's there. He's switching the... Yeah.
Brought a smoke machine.
This game's been around for... Like, they've been working on this for a bit.
Simple pleasures.
Bold choice on the low frame rate character. Kind of cool looking.
Nausicaa vibes.
Yeah.
Oh, for sure. I want to be in a cold, dark room when I play this.
I want to be in a cold room right now.
Cold, dark room.
Crazy.
I dig the music as well. Very nice.
How can we get a stage like that?
Keely.
We gotta talk to Keely.
Yeah.
Keely Bucks.
So time for a new beautiful. Patreon goal.
Thank you, Michelle. Sable will be released on September 23rd this year. That's some news for you. And to learn more about
what
the
did
Sable,
say?
September 23rd.
September
23rd.
Oh, okay.
Amazing game. Watch the Tribeca Game Showcase. That is tomorrow, where Sable was named an official selection of the Legendary Festival. Now, today is just the start of Summer Game Fest. Day of the Devs with I Am 8-Bit and Double Fine will immediately follow the live show today. And there are more events coming all weekend and all month, including the Xbox and Bethesda Games Showcase on Sunday. It's going to be a
good one. Starfield Showcase.
Right now, though, we're thrilled to announce the upcoming Western release of a spectacular 3D massively multiplayer online role-playing game.
Interesting.
Welcome to the world of Lost Ark from Smilegate RPG and Amazon Games.
Okay.
Paying the bills.
Keep the lights on.
No, I'm actually legit interested in this.
The Lost Ark is now but a myth.
Titan Quest.
A relic from the half-remembered Chain War. But now, our world has been torn once again.
I wish I said.
The demons have returned.
What if I could handle you? You sounded like that.
With roaring destruction and waking nightmares.
This is a cool, like, fantasy. Massively co-op.
Okay.
True.
Duh.
Any game that starts has their website that says play, I think, is probably free to play, right?
Sometimes when you play a game, there's that one thing in your inventory which turned out to be far more useful than you first realized. That's kind of like Prime Gaming. If you're an Amazon Prime member, and most of
remember
you probably
when you
are,
got your
you get a ton of gaming goodies every
wrong
month.
And you
this month, you can download Battlefield 4 and Batman the Telltale series completely free for PC. And there are special
don't
in-game
skip the
benefits
Batman Telltale
and perks,
series.
GTA Online, Valorant, Apex Legends, and more that you can unlock.
John's
it's nervous. Awesome value, and John's honestly, this kickoff show would not have been possible without the Prime Gaming folks believing in my vision for a new way to bring you the news this summer. So head over to gaming.amazon.com to check out all the perks and free games, which change every month, but you
does
get
Amazon
to keep them
everything?
Forever.
Yes.
Nearly.
I love new content.
I love new perks, though.
New perks! Every week? New frame traps, not even every week.
Three games?
It's always nice.
Yeah.
Okay, right now I'm honored to be joined by Johanna
you're
Ferris,
bummed.
The new GM yep.
This is exactly
of Call of Duty. Johanna, it's yep. so great to
was
have
this
you
army
with
of
us
two
here
expansions.
On Kickoff Live. I was so excited about what Call of Duty's been doing with all these seasons, and I
you're
know
Salem and Rico,
looks like next week,
skins?
June 17th, Season 4.
Yes, we're super excited. We're super honored to be here, so thank you first and foremost to that. It's just such an amazing time for Call of Duty. We're experiencing such transformational growth and dynamism across the entire brand, you know, from
dynamism.
Premium title releases to everything we'll talk
new
about today.
Yeah. Buzzword,
with Warzone,
dude.
With mobile, with esports, so it's just super incredible.
How
all
the
work. The
dynamism
and shout out to everybody in the, Call of Duty
we,
family
dude,
who makes it happen every day.
It's only a matter of time.
Yeah, no, you've been, I mean, I know season three, it was like, you know, Rambo, Die Hard. Yeah. Now, like, who knows what's in store for season
yo,
four?
Yo, Nakatomi
you guys,
Plaza,
you know,
though,
update
is
the game
sick.
Now with new stuff. Season four is
played like two matches. Really cool.
This is first info on it, so what can you tell the fans watching around the world?
Yeah, we're stoked. It's jam-packed with new content across Cold War and Warzone. You know, you've got new weapons, we've got new maps, we've got badass new operators. I'm super excited about the hijacked gulag. We've got expanded zombies content hijacked for everybody gulag. Who loves Shit, that part dude. Of when this you know, the gameplay drops, experience. So we're thrilled, and I'm excited to bring it forward a little bit
I
here today.
Nakatomi
I know, we've got the first look time, world dude. Premiere trailer Nakatomi of Plaza, season 4, so let's take a look at that now.
Do what you are told, and you get to live. You understand? I knew you were a smart one.
This guy's crazy.
Secure the site.
I guess he didn't get to live.
Cold War just turned hot.
Cold War just turned hot.
Love 2v2. Any game.
Located the satellite.
That looks like that one
Raptor 1. My team's about to be overrun.
One or two.
I am death.
I would be death.
Free content.
Fire train.
June 17th.
That looks so fun. Nice. And 1 week away.
1 week away.
All right, well, let's move on to you first joined Activision to run Call of Duty Esports, and we're going to talk a little bit now about what is the World Series of Warzone, which is going to start on June the 22nd. First of all, tell us what
gotta
is
have
World
lows
Series
of to have
yeah,
the
we're
highs.
Super
True.
Excited
I'm
about
checking
it.
The clock,
really
how much
a
time
new
we
way to highlight competitive
Still time
Call
for
of Duty.
Elden Ring.
You know, we've got great success going with Call of
Full
Duty
hour
League, and now
of
we've got
Ring.
Some of the biggest names in gaming battling it out in Verdansk for what will be the biggest prize pool in Warzone since it's launched, right? So we'll talk a little bit about what that entails, but custom lobby experiences, 150 player to a side squad, so I'm stoked to see
that would be a very easy ally
kind of rally here.
Never played it. What
yes,
is this?
And coming up very go to soon, June 22nd, looks like, looks like Twitch Rivals is going to be a part of this.
Yeah, we are honored to be in partnership with Twitch, always, right? But certainly here with World Series of Warzone and partnering with Twitch Rivals, who's already done so much to really put competitive Warzone on display. So couldn't be in better partnership there, and we're excited to have everybody tune in.
Yes, there is one thing, though, that everyone has been talking about online, and that's who the captains are going to be for the structure of the World Series, at least for the first event.
Has been talking about
I understand
that.
We've getting a little bit reveal so here of who some of the captains
I'm like, shut
are.
Up
yeah,
about these
we love
captains.
The first five captains of the first of many events to come. Like I said, these are huge influencers and personalities in Call of Duty. And they also share our passion for competitive Call of Duty, right? They really believe in the promise of World Series of Warzone and to really level up what it means to really battle it out. So couldn't be happier with some of these names, many of whom also hail from the Call of Duty League yes. family. And I'm excited to see who kind of takes the cake here. We'll see.
I was going to say, they'll all be battling out in just a couple weeks on Twitch Rivals. Well, it's
we
really exciting to see how much you know, Call of Duty is growing into this kind of year-round experience for everyone with so much more content. So we can't wait to see where you're going to take it. And I know there is
Look
a big new mainline game coming later
like
this year, too, right?
Yeah. Indeed, indeed. More details to share
yeah.
later
yeah,
on, but Sledgehammer Games is you know, going to bring forward something
girls
truly incredible. So we're excited.
All right, we tried, guys. There will come a time and a place for that. All right, Johanna, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate it. All right, we've got lots of Summer Game Fest kickoff to go, but right now we've got a surprise guest joining us, my fellow Canadian, Ryan Reynolds. Hey, Ryan.
What?
Well, thank you, Jeff.
Type of free guy.
And hello,
yeah,
Summer Game Fest.
Sure.
Now, I know what you're thinking, and no, I'm not here to announce I'm the star of Elden Ring.
You son,
you,
of
you son of
you
a bitch!
You son of a bitch!
You son of a
You can't say it!
You remember those things?
Go play Pikachu and
look,
shut up!
I have a new movie coming
it's
out
coming.
August 13th called
closing
Free
the
Guy.
Show.
And in this movie, I play an NPC character
the show.
No.
In a popular
told
open
world
video
that.
Game. Until I break free and I realize that it kind of sucks to be a you know lonely background character on an endless walk cycle. So now here's one of those world premieres.
Totally
it's the first ever
somewhere.
Look at our
so
cast
I'll
on the big
trailer.
Screen
yeah.
this August. And honestly, it's been so long I can't even remember who's even in this movie. I didn't say that. I'll cut that out. Yeah, I'll do it right now.
My name is Guy. I thought I had everything I needed.
Mondays, am I right, Joe?
You said it, guy.
But then this comes out, I met her.
At home. I'll
watch it. Oh, my God!
This is a home viewer.
Glasses or something?
If this happens to be on at the dentist,
no, yo, this is a remix. We need to remix this.
Remix.
Oh, no.
And the guy responsible for this world is going to destroy it.
Actually, I might see this just...
You've met God?
Yes, he's an absolute troll.
Trolls exist. We can save our world.
I'm sure it's a coincidence, but we did pitch Seaton to Disney.
I don't have it right now, but I love it!
Not accusing anyone of anything. It's not a completely original idea.
That actually hurt my hand.
I have three words for you. Blue shirt guy.
This guy is outskilling all these players.
I've never seen
anything like this.
Who the hell even knows who this blue shirt guy is?
He's also really cute.
The game wasn't even made for someone like this.
Terminate him.
Taiki Waititi right there, dude.
Do love me some Taiki.
I think it's going to be such a train wreck, I have to be.
Remix.
August.
That was fun seeing Ninja, Doki, Jacksepticeye, Laserbeam.
Oh, January is in August.
That movie is like...
Ryan had to say it. I can't say it
was
yet.
Made
right.
In a boardroom.
Next,
by
he said yet. Awards at the Game Awards, and Among Us just keeps going.
He said yet.
Now it's time to hear from Inner Sloth on what's coming next.
Roadmap.
Among Us isn't fun unless you're accusing Jones of being the murderer. Dude, every time.
He never gets to be fun. Hide and Seek could be fun.
Is it like a slight breath of luck?
That's a little...
Director's cut.
Hard to tell. No different dead.
No.
Stats.
The thumbs up. Nice touch.
Very cool.
Lots of fun ahead. And speaking of...
Damn it, Jeff!
Last year, you may remember the very rare Jeff Keighley mask was available as a Twitch drop around the Game Awards.
I don't remember that at all, actually.
Again. In fact, I often hear on Twitter from people who get booted from games with the mask because folks think that they're hacked. Well, never fear. Today, the mask is back. Just head to Twitch, connect your account, and watch 15
what
minutes or more of
like?
Kickoff Live
yeah,
to get your very own Jeff Keighley mask.
I remember them wearing
once again,
one
and then it goes back into the vault.
But I don't remember.
I don't know what's going on. All right. Speaking of independent developers, now I'm very happy to welcome to Summer Game Fest the head of indies at PlayStation, a legend in his own right, who has some exciting things to share.
Daddy.
Shuhei Yoshida. Hi, Shu.
Thanks, Jeff. Hi, everyone. I'm Shuhei Yoshida, head of PlayStation Indies.
Love Shu.
What I love about working with independent developers are the new and unexpected games that they create, which allows us to offer an array of unique experiences for players. In my role at Sony, it's very exciting to get to meet with these talented studios, which sometimes can be one person or a small group of friends, to help nurture their ideas and bring them to the PlayStation fans. One example is from Finji, who has been working with Greg Lobanov, the developer of Wondersong, to publish their new game, Chicory, A Colorful Tale. Chicory released today and gives players a chance to experience a coloring book-style world where players use their painting powers to explore, solve puzzles, make friends, and draw on anything.
If he said it comes out today.
Check out Chicory, A Colorful Tale on PlayStation 4 or PlayStation 5 after the show.
Yeah.
As a huge Soulspawn games fan, I totally enjoyed the beautiful 2D action adventure Salt and Sanctuary a few years ago.
Oh, Salt Sanctuary?
The developer Ska Studio has been hard at work on a new title, which I'm proud present to you. Salt the new and Sacrifice.
I met these devs. They're super cool.
Salt and Sacrifice.
Wow.
Salt Sacrifice.
Sequel.
Our sins will catch up with us.
I never finished the first one. it's good.
I did not care for the first one, but I'm totally willing to give it a shot.
I liked it. I didn't finish it, but I
obliterated.
I was given a second chance. I spoke the words. I drank the mage bane.
Ooh, grapple gun. Yep.
I live now.
Only hunt mages! Yes! Take him out.
Goaty.
Yep. Goaty right here.
Super hates mages.
This is Goaty.
Dude, cool. Rip out their hearts and crush them in your hand.
Mage to power,
but together
we will take co-op mages. Yes, dude.
We'll hunt mages together.
Yes.
I'm stoked for this.
Hell yeah.
2022.
Sick.
Very cool. Yeah.
Thanks, Shu. And that's not all. Today, we're also able to share with you a brand new trailer from the upcoming Annapurna and Heart Machine game, Solar Ash, which is coming to PlayStation later this year.
Oh, it's so pretty.
My boy Jack designed that main character.
Boots.
Sonic Adventure 2 hype.
Yep. This is some dummy on
Shadow of the Colossus.
Yeah, right, Shadow of the Colossus.
Yeah. Damiani just leaned into the monitor.
Damiani glanced away from his 4K copy of Advent to look at the screen.
He's just looking at the disc.
Yeah.
Straight up Shadow of the Colossus. Okay.
Nice. 2021. I'm down.
2021.
Yeah, it looks sick.
That looks so, so great. Can't wait to see it later this year. Now, this week, there is a ton of video game news, but there's also a big game launching across console and PC, Chivalry 2, which brings 60
new
battles to light.
Hattie
Sledgehammers,
blast.
Swords, axes, you name it. And it comes from Torrent Manor Studios in my hometown.
It's out. It's out. We streamed.
Here's a lot of launch trailer for Chivalry 2, which you can play right now.
Only $40, too, everyone out there watching. It's not a full price game. It's only $40.
And do not pick Archer.
If you're on Archer, unsubscribe to Easy on the
Strange Field.
Archer's yellow. Well.
Dude, just the map where it's just a face off.
This is trailer, like, the music's really tense, but I feel like when we're playing, it's much more lighthearted.
Yeah.
The music
just throw your weapon. Yeah. This map is sick.
Yeah.
I love this map.
Good fun factor.
Yes.
This game.
Yes, this is a Game Pro Fun Factor 5.0. Yeah. Absolutely.
Dude, I want to yell that.
Who's Agatha?
It's one of the sides.
Yeah.
Agatha and the Mason. Yeah, tons of fun. I didn't know you could throw people's heads.
I didn't know that
either. Dude! Oh, and you can. Did you see launch yourself in catapults?
Sick! Are the controls good?
They take a little bit to get used to, but once you do, they feel really good, yeah.
Yes. Very awesome. I want to play right now.
Yeah.
Me too.
Put it up. Put it up.
Yeah, I want to play right now.
This month, Valorant from Riot celebrated its one-year anniversary, and starting next Monday, June 14th, Prime Gaming members will get an exclusive player card to celebrate the one-year anniversary and a pity party spray through June 25th. This is all leading up to the release of Episode 3 of the game later this month, which will be celebrated with an epic WW Fest unlocked year one stream on June 25th.
Yeah,
but there will also be a new agent Who could it be? Well, here's your first very, very exclusive but very, very quick tease to whet your appetite with more to be revealed later this month.
I don't know what's going on.
I don't think Keely knows what's going on.
I don't know what's going on.
I love it, dude.
I
don't know what's going on. Flying by the seat of his pants, dude.
Bastion?
A robot? That was very quick.
Okay. Very cool.
As advertised.
I told you it was very, very quick. PMC factions face
it's like he can hear us.
He tells the truth.
Yeah.
The popular multiplayer first-person shooter video game developed by Battlestate Games. Today, we've got an exclusive new look at the streets of Tarkov, the new area of the game under development.
I still need to check this out.
Valorant?
No. Escape from Tarkov.
Oh, yeah, me too. Very
once
big
it's like
on
fully released?
Stream.
Is it fully released?
It's like the number one streaming.
I know.
Is anything like fully released ever anymore?
They should just never release games anymore. Because then
don't.
They always have an excuse.
Already in that timeline. Yeah. I want to give this a spin.
Feels like a game that looks really good that I would be so bad at.
Yeah, I definitely think you're bad for hours in this.
You're going to be like fiddling around with your inventories and weapons for
my
45
head is gone.
Minutes,
yeah.
And then you just get sniped and die.
Yeah. Fiddle and die.
Flashlights. Now that my computer is good, I can actually probably play this game.
Yeah, dude.
This would be a good group stream.
Certainly on meta.
Like Rainbow Six, but more intense.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a huge survival element. Like, the inventory is very survival-based.
Oh, really?
Like a survival game.
I've seen the inventory, and it looked dense. Children of Men. Blood on the lens.
You're out.
Doesn't bother me in game. Yeah, no.
Surprise, motherfucker!
Ooh.
Edge. Breach.
Edge TM.
Great fight.
Dude,
love the blinding flashlight.
Yeah, the blurry is
so cool.
I don't know, considering how excellent we are at video games.
Yeah. It's physically great.
Yeah.
It's always intimidating playing a game that you know the players are so invested.
Freaks. I can it's smell like, the intimidation from here.
I'm so intimidated.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like Escape from Tarkov players, like, before they play, they had a raw steak, you know? It's like their pre-game meal.
Raw meat!
Yeah,
raw meat!
Yeah.
Just
get ready for Escape?
When I was a kid, the simulation games of Peter Molyneux were some of my favorites.
Uh-oh.
Adding
extra
salt on the fries in the theme park to increase your drink sales was so devilish. Well, many of the team members behind those sim games went on to create 2 Point Studios and 2 Point Hospital.
Yeah. Oh,
well,
2 Point Campus.
Today, we're excited to share the first trailer for their next 2 Point simulation, 2 Point Campus.
Has this been our like most major E3 leak?
That first sight of the school gates, the scent of a leather-bound book, the faint clatter of knights jousting. Well, I can't say I remember that part, though it wasn't like this in my day.
The 2 Point Hospital.
Campuses are forever changing. Nowadays, education has to be fun.
All about it. Give me the drama. Give me the college drama.
I want a list of everything you love. I love campuses.
Academia has never been more appealing, more dynamic, more whatever this
drama.
Is.
Coming of age.
That's true. You do love
today's campus is a place to live and a place to learn. Finally crafted by the sharpest minds that money can buy.
I would love it if
sometimes
thing and
you still can't get the stuff. Yes, these days it really does feel as though anything is possible.
Oh. Oh, okay, yeah. So the student's major changes what their outfit is. I was wondering, because in Two-Point Hospital, what people are sick with, like, changes their costume.
Two-Point Campus? Class is in session 2022.
Yeah, that was fun.
Yes. Good work.
We got Clown College in there.
This year, I am thrilled to have Netflix as a part of Summer Game Fest. They have been doing an incredible job adapting
games
to series like Castlevania and the Dota anime. Well, there is a lot more coming, and you don't have to wait long to find out more. Tomorrow, I'm honored to be guest hosting Netflix's Geeked Week live stream with Mari Takahashi and Buhu Kohli. You can expect the first clip of the Cuphead show, which, spoiler alert, this show is going to be an absolute sensation.
Hey, how about that Cuphead DLC? That'd
be cool. I'll also sit down with the team behind Arcane, the League of Legends animated show coming later this year, and we might also have updates on The Witcher and the live-action Resident Evil series. Geeked Week is streaming live tomorrow at 9 a.m.
What about
the
live-action Cowboy Bebop?
That's some juice.
It's been in the darkness right now, too.
What is Geeked Week? Netflix Geeked is hosting a free virtual event full of big news, exciting first looks, and the people who make the shows and films you love on Netflix. Comics,
10
games,
out of 10.
Movies,
10 out of 10 isn't
zombies, animation, sci-fi, fantasy.
Okay, the content are the other fair. No black eye has a
Are they making a Splinter Cell show?
People you love,
Relic
the shows you love,
not the game, but the show.
Grab your devices, tuck in, and join Netflix Geeked for Geeked Week. There's so much to get geeked about.
Hey, if it happens at Geeked Week, it counts. If Sam Fisher's running and
we aren't done with Netflix just yet, though. Coming up next is Smite, a
cross-platform
game.
Let's jump back into Smite. I still have all gods forever because of that thing.
Well, as Smite enters its ninth year, it's time to go upside down.
What?
Wait. Another Stranger Things game?
I missed everything you said about
Smite.
No.
It's a show? In Smite.
Oh, okay.
Dude, Stranger Things 3, the game.
Hit you. Stranger Things in Smite, huh?
Yeah, what? This seems weird.
Is 11 just going to be a sequel to those cars with people?
Yeah, dude.
What if they just put cars all over every map so that you can throw them?
Yeah. Wait, Stranger Things Cross Smite is not the crossover I expected.
Not expected. Yeah.
What, they've done Avatar and Turtles?
Oh,
well, and Dead by Daylight.
And Dead by Daylight. Yeah.
Star Court 11. Oh, they're like...
Hopper swinging in,
dude. We gotta play this.
Yeah.
We gotta play this.
Holy shit.
Yeah, we have to.
There you go.
July. Featuring an upside down arena map. Cool.
Next up, we announce a lot of games on my shows, but I think this is the first time we are announcing an entirely new game label, new game publisher. Enjoy this first look at more than 12 games that make up its initial slate.
Does this count as all those world premieres he was teasing?
Sometimes I ask myself what it all means. Let's begin.
I agree about it, Jensen.
Is that who you are?
My purpose makes me who I am.
I finally have the feeling we're doing something worthwhile.
Being relied on to succeed where others would fail.
You're ungrateful. Outward, I want to speak on dominance so bad it's in the world.
I also want to fail.
Yeah. It's Switzerland. E3? Prime Matter. Hey, who's in development? It's like a couple years away, I heard.
Prime Matter.
Strange.
There you have it. Prime Matter, Payday 3 2. And there is actually one more game added to the mix. And for that, we go to Todd Hollinshead from Saber. Todd, how you doing?
I'm great, Jeff. Thank you for the intro there. I'm really excited to have this little last addition, which is that Saber and Prime Matter are working together on a new game in the Painkiller franchise.
Whoa! Oh, shit.
All right, very cool on that. And there are more details
that was a hard
on Prime
cut.
Matter.
See you later, Joe.
With a stream at noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern, and I will be stopping by. Next up is a brand new IP from a brand new studio, Stray Bombay. It's coming this fall only to Xbox, PC, and Game Pass on day one. It's called The Anacrusis, a four-player cooperative first-person shooter set aboard a massive starship stranded at the edge of explored space. You team up with your friends in an infinitely replayable fight against alien hordes to unlock perks, weapons, and new ways to play that you can share with your team. Here is the world premiere trailer.
Because like some of the mods, some of the expansions were like glorified mods that they made. Like it's
different era.
He had a feeling.
Yeah.
Nessa, Liu, Slav, Dion.
Oh,
stick
right.
Together and let's do it.
Yeah, it does have.
Kind of getting deathly vibes.
Is this a disco? This I do not like.
I could use some help. Hit your pulse.
Okay, World War Z was
good. Not good. Not good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was. Open the doors and run. Just run. No stopping. No shooting. Just straight
fun
to
enough.
The bridge.
Yeah, the feedback on killing the enemy is always
really
feeling there. But
we call them tanks.
Seems fun.
I call them brutes.
An entreat.
From Latin, Brutus.
We'd sound smart calling them brutes.
Eon, you don't want to get in here and help name these?
Nah, I'm good.
Brute!
Where are the codes?
Awesome look. Thanks for that, Chet, and the team at Stray Bombay.
Awesome
tomorrow,
look.
Tune into Summer Game Fest for a special deep dive presentation
New
on New World, a
MMO
Amazon games.
They like need
the
that to succeed
island
too. If that bombs,
it's finally
dude,
coming out later
what's
this
gonna
summer.
Happen
and
there?
In the deep dive video, game director game Scott games. Lane will take players into the mysterious
like
supernatural
I think
island
okay.
that is a world
yeah,
of
war.
Once you arrive, it's up to you to unite warring human factions to take on a common enemy, the Tempest.
I think I saw Damiani or somebody
life.
Streaming
Scott
this,
and the team will detail
like
updates to the game, including
like, wow,
new mid and end
slow.
Game content, more PvE and expeditions,
like
five-player challenges with unique mechanics, bosses, loot,
spin.
And more. Six of these expeditions
I love new MMOs.
Will be at launch with the
yeah.
closed beta
a
on
new
July
MMO,
20th
day one,
and the public launch
electric.
On August 31st.
Yeah, right?
I will also
come on.
Down
yeah. And how often does that happen anymore?
The game,
not
the
often. Yeah.
Efforts over
exactly.
the past year in the midst of COVID.
Yeah.
It is exciting for me
day one.
To finally
day
be able
one.
To get out there. And
probably
the
only day one.
Again. Yeah. I miss all these
It'll
developers.
Be a good day.
Yeah. Check out the special deep dive stream on New World tomorrow at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern at summergamefest.com. All right, well, back in 2018, Rocket League teamed up with Fast and Furious.
Oh, yeah,
bring
Rocket
some of the
League.
Saga's most iconic cars into the game.
My friend Reed
and now
is excited.
They are back with
F9.
A twist that is truly Rocket League with Fast 9, the next installment of the Fast
bring
Saga,
Vin out.
Arriving
space
in U.S.
Map.
Theaters June 25th. Psyonix is bringing back the Nissan Skyline, Dodge Charger, and, well,
Skyline.
Maybe the most
Skyline.
Literal supersonic,
Skyline,
acrobatic,
GTR,
rocket-powered heist car ever conceived, the F9 Pontiac Fiero.
I love Skylines, dude, and GTRs.
I feel like I should take you shopping
when I'm like, under Kelly Blue Book Dahlia, dude.
Me pongo furiosa. Cada vez que tú me miras. Yo prefiero estar sola.
Every game has a drop out.
Me pongo furiosa. Furiosa.
Furiosa. Furiosa. Furiosa. Furiosa.
Love it.
Strap a rocket engine to a car and play soccer. Seems like the right idea to me. The Fast and Furious.
It's like he's seen it after the
June
first
17th
time.
In yeah. Rocket League. Okay, next up, last year, a new Swedish company named Shark Mob released a teaser for their first unnamed multiplayer project in the Vampire the Masquerade universe. We're putting a name on their first game with a brand new world premiere trailer.
Sam. Hard to remember games with no name.
Nosgoth.
Yeah.
Nosgoth. Nosgoth.
How many Vampire the Masquerade games are we going to get?
How many will actually come out?
Yeah, well, yeah. So,
five.
So far, like, one has come out that they announced.
Maintaining the Masquerade. We have influenced your society. Fed on your blood. Thrived among you. Until now.
Blood Hunt.
So is it 4v4?
I don't know what it is.
I can't wait to play this game.
They're
and
just
we
abandoning the Masquerade.
Won't have to wait long. You can sign up now for the bloodhunt.com is where you go for the closed alpha PC test available on July 2nd. Blood Hunt will be released later this year.
We should probably sign up for that.
Yeah, we should definitely sign up for that.
Next, the latest horror game series from the creators of Until Dawn continues with the House of Ashes.
Let's go.
Yeah, dude, full playthrough.
Let's do it.
Full stream. In person now.
Here's the story trailer with the exclusive reveal of the monsters lurking in the depths.
He got really excited about that. He got really into that.
Sometimes he's got
to... Oh, God, is it going to be underwater?
I think there's it's like caves.
Oh shit!
Descent.
Yeah.
Bugs.
Oh man.
Mm-hmm. I still need to get through that movie. I got too scared.
Oh. Descent one.
An ancient horror.
That's what I hear.
Has awoken from its slumber and is hungry for blood.
If the final one is not in that mansion,
Yeah, like somehow
satellite
dealing with the people
the
like
war zone having covered what appears to be an underground storage facility.
There's a war focus on this one.
What I strongly suspect. Where chemical weapons are hidden, so we need to move fast.
Chemical weapons?
Ready to go, guard.
To descend into the unknown alone is extremely brave.
Man out, hold fire.
Or extremely foolish.
We're gonna sigh out this shit.
Brothers in arms.
Pretty cool, we're soldiers this time instead of like
each man for himself.
Down, get down! They're up on the roof! Return fire!
You teeter. On the edge of an abyss.
Do my whole school.
For survival,
everybody's out.
You make, they will be as a compass guiding you through the unknown.
On God's green earth have we landed.
What nightmare have these luckless souls fallen into?
You keep lookout.
Lookout? Lookout for what?
One by one, their lights will be snuffed out. Unless you can find the means to save them. Trapped beneath the earth. Swallowed.
She was like covered in blood.
Let's go.
The
boy.
Classic.
Will you find the path to salvation?
They watched it numerous times.
Yeah.
They
watched it.
They had it on repeat.
Dude, gas mask guy.
Forever.
Cool. Just in time for Halloween.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
Oh, they showed it.
That looked pretty cool. All
right. Kind of wish they didn't show it.
Yeah, it
but they had to. They had to sell the figurine. Okay.
They had to sell the figurine.
Weird that it's called House of Ashes, but it takes place in a ruin underground.
Curator's cut.
One of the
director's cut. Curator's cut. New hotness.
Franchises in the industry: the Tales of series. Well, the latest Tales of Rise was announced 2 years ago, and it brings the franchise into stunning 3D with Unreal Engine 4. Here's a world premiere look at the latest trailer with more information following in the coming weeks.
You mean at the band, I think.
Yeah.
I love the coming.
Like, no, huh? Daniel Plainview? It looked like oil.
Dude, Bloody Edge.
Bloody Edge.
Daniel
Pretty fancy place they got here.
Harmony and coexistence.
Yeah.
Between the Renans.
Setting that shit's Japanese immediately.
I'm Dohin and Minokaris. Should you need my skills on the battlefield, all I care for is maintaining peace.
I'm Captain Kisara of the Elder Menencia Gaul. Ha! Flare the Malisha! From now on, when I fight to protect my dream.
Well, this crew just gets bigger and bigger. Well?
The Renans. Seems the rumors you were running with them were true.
So good.
Get toasty!
Big leap.
Burst. Yeah.
They brought it to 3D with Unreal Engine 4.
Demon Fang or not pre-ordering?
It'll be there, dude.
Been looking for you.
All of you, get the hell out of my realm! This is Tannen's realm and it's ours, understand?
Get the hell out of my realm.
It's only
wanna play
just
this
begun.
Hot cocoa.
What was the Cold Dark Room game?
Shit. Sable.
Sable.
Sable, dude. Cold Dark Room.
Cold Dark Room.
Cold Dark Room.
Day
September
zero.
10th.
Day zero.
September
Let's 10th. Go.
That's coming.
Yeah, I'll be there.
The Petite Prince.
That game company.
Oh, yeah.
Yo.
Oh, shit.
Journeys.
For Summer Game Fest, we have a special announcement for you. That the console version of Sky Children of the Light would arrive to Nintendo Switch on June 29th.
Sick. Huh.
And the Little Prince season would start soon after on July 6th. Enjoy the game.
That. Delightful.
Mm-hmm.
Love it.
Awesome.
I'll play it.
Yep. Been waiting.
One of the things I take great pleasure in is using a platform like this show to introduce you to new developers and studios with games that deserve the spotlight. That's definitely the case with this next title from a small Swedish studio named Wishfully. Planet of Lana tells the story of a young girl and her loyal friend who embark on a mission through a colorful world that's designed to feel like a gouache watercolor painting come to life. Here's your first look at the Planet of Lana coming to Xbox and PC in 2022.
Let's
check Twitter.
Everybody's been talking about the captains.
Thunderful. Wishfully. I'm in.
Oh. In.
Yeah, they could just cut here and I'd be safe.
Uh-oh. Ooh! Spaceships?
Invaders. Sky people.
Lots of sky people.
Woo! Actually kind of reminded me of PSO2.
Too.
Playing out with a bag of blue diamonds.
Lightly salted?
In a nice warm
sea salt
room.
And vinegar.
Nice.
Ooh. Yeah. Planet of Lana, Lana.
Lara.
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 Lana Craft.
Lara.
What a beautiful artistic.
Blizzard has arrived, man.
Blizzard has arrived.
Well, joining me now is Aaron Keller, who's the game director of Overwatch 2. Aaron, great to have you here on Kickoff Live. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much for having us here.
Yeah, we are excited to learn more about what's planned for Overwatch 2. You guys recently, you had a PvP live stream that I watched, and you revealed some changes coming to Overwatch 2. What can you tell us? What's the latest?
Yeah, so we recently announced that Overwatch 2's format is changing to a 5v5 team format. This requires a fresh look at all of our heroes in the game. It should feel new yet familiar to fans of our strategic team-based combat.
Yeah, it was great to see you guys playing, and long awaited for people to get a chance to go hands-on with it. And today, I know you brought us a look at some skins for some of the characters, right?
Yeah, yes. The team is so passionate about skins. Updating the Pain look the and the feel of the world of Overwatch. And one aspect of that is creating entirely new models for Overwatch 2 for all of our heroes. Wow. So today we're going to be looking at two of those, Baptiste and Sombra.
All right, well, let's take a look here. And I know you're going to tell us a little bit about what we're seeing, but it's so cool to see these characters brought into Overwatch 2. So yeah, what do we got here?
Yeah, so this is Baptiste. And there's a lot of new technology that go into our models. We have new hair shader tech, excuse me, in order to get the look that we're going for with his haircut. He also has a glowing cape and gloves that kind of give that medic or surgeon vibe to him.
Do the floss!
We're going to Sombra, I think, right?
Yep, so next up is Sombra. This was a very challenging look for us to update. It's an asymmetrical design. There's so many layers of hair and clothing and technology in this.
So cool.
If you look closely, you can actually see circuitry and nodes embedded in her clothing. She is a world-class hacker, so it all makes sense.
No, again, it's so great for fans to see these characters you know and love. From the first game, updated for Overwatch 2, and we can't wait to see more
That's
on
it.
The game. We
appreciate
Boy,
it's a real drip feed.
Wow. The most drip ever.
You bet,
dude.
Thank you.
Awesome. All right. Thanks very much,
Aaron. I'm glad I'm not here
now, recently I had a chance to play Dungeons & Dragons Dark Alliance with the game developer Jeff Haddam.
I would love to see
Ember Moon from the WWE.
That would be fun.
That's right. You didn't expect me to say that. But this game is
WWE,
a ton of fun, and it's coming to Game Pass on June 22nd. Take a look.
Love Blood and Gold.
Hey guys,
users
Keely,
interact.
And today, as part of Summer Game Fest, we are going hands-on with a game that is coming out in just a couple
Drizzy.
Of weeks. It is Dark Alliance, and we've got Jeff, one of the game developers from 2K. Jeff, special guests, Hannibal Buress and Ember Moon.
Okay.
What is this?
That looks
Hannibal
like Traps.
I would love to play this with Hannibal Buress.
Oh my god.
I love
Traps.
Him.
Bird up.
Oh,
bird up.
People.
Oh, no, you get
it.
A warrior's so death, I died again.
I'm coming to get you.
Hey.
Oh.
Watch it.
Oh.
It
oh,
looks
no.
like she's.
Oh, Amber's no, I can't believe I'm down.
Armor.
I'm down,
Respect.
People.
The developer's down.
The dev
what?
Is down.
So, Ember,
the
I know you really
down.
Wanted to be Drist.
Absolutely.
Right?
I've read all the books, especially the Drist backstory, and I just connected with it on such an intimate level to the point where my wrestling character that everyone sees on TV is actually based on this character. The
so,
red
whoa.
Eyes, even though Drist has cool. purple, I just love everything about
like
him, that he's just constantly the good guy the entire time.
Oh, what the?
Oh.
He's the Verbeek chef.
That doesn't look healthy at all. Why'd I just
all
run
right,
up on him?
Butcher,
nothing
on
us, baby.
I'm here now.
Oh, the chef is definitely a less intimidating name than the butcher.
Come on. Come
it's
on.
In a fire
you
arena,
too.
It's like literally the same as
there
the butcher.
Let's go!
Damn, what a death. I'm having some weird dreams tonight because of that. Oh, he flipped us off!
Act complete.
What is the tone of this game?
I'm not sure. Coming up.
Yep, coming up.
We'll stream it, bro.
Is that going to be
Game
good?
Pass.
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, is it on Game Pass?
It's sick.
Paladins.
Never
heard this game.
What was the epic one that
just pretty funny that the Paladins trailer came out after the Overwatch.
Mm-hmm.
They're
I mean, show him more of the game.
That is true.
Seriously, actual gameplay.
Yeah.
Any of the games? Like, I don't know what the fuck they're showing with Overwatch.
Yeah.
Like,
here's this two new character
characters in a white room.
A lot like Remix.
All right, Summer Game Fest Kickoff Live presented by Prime Gaming continues. Yesterday was an amazing tease of the next Battlefield from EA.
Left?
And if you want to dust up on the history of the franchise, its last big modern-day game, that was Battlefield 4. It's this month. Prime Gaming members get to download it and play it for free through June 20th. Now, there's no catch. This is the full-blown PC version of the 2013 game, and those only in Battlefield moments still hold up.
No malware.
Just head to gaming.amazon.com to redeem your free copy right now if you are an Amazon Prime member. And this Sunday, watch the Xbox and Bethesda Game Showcase for the first gameplay footage of Battlefield 2042. Going to be really cool. All right, right now, let's take a look at another world premiere.
Back to
Monster Hunter Stories is coming to the Switch in July.
Monster Hunter Stories.
We've got your first look at the story trailer.
No catch. A Capcom and Nintendo.
Feels good.
Wings of Ruin.
You don't understand. That Rathalos is...
My dad. I understand the Rathalos.
I watched the movie.
Yep.
Yo, I know all the lore, dude. I've seen the movie.
Yeah, dude.
Very accurate.
Do you remember Ron Perlman?
Looking weird, dude.
Yeah.
Haggard.
I kind of want to rewatch that.
I mean, watching it with you guys was...
We can't let you interfere with our plans.
We have an audio commentary of us watching this movie on our Patreon. Haha, check it out.
You suppose he saw this coming?
This is like a Kingdom Hearts trailer with no sound effects.
Yeah.
And voiceover.
I love how this is the story trailer, and on one hand, I don't have a good sense of the story, and on the other hand, I know what it is exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, it does. The style is just so good.
So, you're going to be born, huh?
Okay. Nothing better than final lines in JRPG
in
trailers.
In JRPG trailers.
They are the best.
Inexplicable. Yeah. Every time. Yeah. So you're going to be born, huh?
Gotta get on those. They're gonna be sold that quick.
Oh, yeah.
Link the save data.
That was too fast for me to comprehend.
Where are the codes?
Next, this legendary rock band throw this summer on the Hella Mega Tour with Green Day and Fallout Boy. But first, they came together with an indie developer to create stream-safe music for the community.
Aha!
Yes, you can co-stream this performance. So turn it
up.
Thank
you, Jeff.
Premiering their brand new, never-before-released song, Tell Me What You Want, from Wavebreak. This is Weezer!
He's so amped.
He loves Weezer.
He loves him.
Yo. Wavebreak. Is it Wavebreak?
Message that my manager wouldn't approve. After this song, he'll have a lot of cleaning up to do. Don't be influenced by an office full of dorks.
This has to be, it's a game, right?
Yeah.
I won't mention any names. Pitchfork.
Pitchfork? Like Randy Pitchfork or Pitchfork?
I'm gonna get right on.
I choose to believe he's talking about it.
Tell me what you want. I'll write it down in my notebook. Duly noted. Tell me what you want. If it's gonna make you happy, I'll give you my guitar. Show me all your heart licks. Damn, that's cool.
Tony Hawk.
Yeah.
For your animals.
Don's excited.
I need a taste maker to tell me which way to go.
Got synths back there, nobody's using them.
So I can play the halftime show at the Super Bowl.
High school locker, I have the Queen album sticker.
I'm remember that.
Inside of my locker.
That fit.
Checks out.
This has to be a rap.
Wait for 3 seconds. Tell me what you
want. I'm gonna get right on. It's like sleepy rock. Tell me what you want. It's like sleepy rock. I'll write it down in my notebook. Duly noted. Tell me what you want. Is that an actual song? Actually,
kind of has a green album.
Yeah.
Five. Show me all your hot dicks. Damn, that's
cool. Well, say, baby, love me. Are we almost there? Say, baby. Should I bleach my hair? How long have they been around them? 20 years?
I'd say they missed
over, probably. No, I mean, right now, though, they've seen
yeah,
it.
Yeah,
yeah. They've still, yeah, still got it.
No shade in, like,
30 years.
Yeah. I fell off hard after this album. Beverly Hills, all that.
I really
not
like
the
Mallet Train a lot. I like the
Bird.
And there's some good stuff after that. I like some stuff after that. But, falling off, yes.
Thank you. Use the prophet!
Boo out.
Yup.
Yup. GG, Weezer.
GG.
Yeah.
That was so amazing. thank you, Rivers and guys, for that. Both the song and the game released tomorrow on PC, Nintendo Switch, music streaming platforms, Twitch soundtrack, and a limited edition 7-inch vinyl on IM 8-bit. All right, well, right now, let's turn to a game that we announced last year at the Game Awards, Endless Dungeon from Amplitude. We showed a brief glimpse of gameplay in December, and fans wanted more. Well, here's an extended look at Endless Dungeon.
How much time we got?
12:18.
We're stuck in this wreck until everybody learns the rules.
Theoretically,
yep.
It's exactly 90.
All of them. Rule number one. Certain weapons work better on certain monsters. Learn it or die. Oh, option B then. Rule number two, use turrets to protect that unstable dust bomb we call the crystal. Because it's their catnip.
Yeah.
And if it goes, you go. Yep. Just like that. Rule number three.
The last line.
Watch your slack.
I love camping the objective. I got this.
Even if you got the
see, I thought you'd be like out way too far. That's yeah.
You can't do everything by yourself.
We've all played Dead by Daylight. We know
if you fight alone, like, you die alone.
Ooh, that was good. That was good.
Together again. And rule number four?
It's like Battlefield, so you're just like well, defending the base.
If you've got all that going, but you still can't win, you gotta change the squad. Tag team. I'm in.
Yeah.
Sega!
Sega!
What are you guys doing tonight? If you're lucky enough to have a PS5, you're probably getting ready to play Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart. Yeah, I've been playing it and having a ton of fun. Well, later today, the team at Insomniac is going to be doing a special launch stream on Twitch. And to tell us more, take it away, Marcus and Mike.
Hey, Jeff, and everybody watching Summer Games Fest Kickoff Live.
Marcus
Smith here, creative director at Insomniac Games for Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart. We're excited that players finally get a chance to play the game tomorrow and celebrate.
Oh, yeah.
I want to spend some more time with you today. At 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern, to live stream the first hour of Rift Apart. Isn't that right, Mike?
That's right. I'm Mike Daly.
April 5 is good, but I expected it. I don't know. I've been hearing
this in a world where
we live in a world where like nines are handed out like candy.
I know. April 5 is a good score.
So please join us at twitch.tv/insomniacgames at 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern.
Oh,
just like recoil.
No, but for real, what's wrong with
it? Yeah. What happened to you as a child that made you not love this game?
Damn it. All right, we're now about to be joined by the one and only Giancarlo Esposito to talk Far Cry 6. Giancarlo, thank you for joining us. Why did you want to take on this?
He came to me with this phenomenal idea.
I love this man.
And had proposed that I play Anton Castillo, the leader of Yara.
I like how he seems so happy and nice in real life. He always plays monsters.
And it really appealed to me because he was a guy who first came from a love of his family and a love of his community and country. And it was so in line with what's going on in the world politically today and what has happened in the past. I thought, what a great opportunity. The other part of it is it's just a different technology that's so brand new. It excites me as a filmmaker that I wanted to be a part of it.
All right, well, you've played some absolutely amazing villains in your career. What was it like being a video game villain?
No, I'm not a villain. I got to push back on you. I'll let you finish. But this guy loves his country. He wants to empower you, Keeley. He wants to empower you to stand up and speak your truth. Now you can go back to calling me.
You are smiling on the box. You're a good guy, right?
I am, because I feel like we as human beings fall in line. And I want to be a renegade within reason. How do you like that? Because I think part and parcel of us falling in line and doing what we need to do and thinking about the cumulative effect of our doing what's right and the example of that is also to stand up and say, no, I do agree that there are good and bad about all people, but this guy, out of his love and passion for his people, even if they're faceless to him at certain points in time, allow him to be an absolute hero.
Speaking of your character, who did you base him on or study to create this character?
It's so interesting because, of course, the obvious choice to study is Fidel Castro, and it is Cuba, an island that had so many resources. But really, the dream of the ability of the dictator to cultivate those resources, something got in the way there. And hopefully that can change in the years to come. It's funny you asked me that question, because I was just talking to one of my daughters about Ceausescu and also Hitler, because we were talking about zodiac signs and what signs were certain people. What is that mindset that has you wanting to have power over others? And for each dictator, it's different. She'd never heard of Ceausescu and studied political science and all this in college.
All right, well, one last question for you. Who would win in a square off between Gus Fring, Moff Gideon, and Anton?
You know, and I have my favorites in those two. You asked me this question. And you know, immediately I say Moff Gideon. Immediately. You know, somehow I think Gus is colder and displays that coldness in a very particular way. You know, I think Anton could be the most violent man on earth, but given his situation, he may not rise to that occasion or may not have the time. Moff Gideon is otherworldly. This guy thinks in a different way, and he knows what you're thinking before you say it. And he does all his own dirty work, and he has an incredible tool to help him out. So I'm going to say Moff Gideon.
Fair enough. All right, Giancarlo, thank you so much for hanging out with us. We will check out the revolution in Far Cry 6.
And I can't wait for it to begin. Let the games begin!
Awesome. All right, thank you so much.
So hyped.
You haven't picked up on it yet. Yeah, Prime Gaming unlocks a ton of in-game benefits for Amazon Prime members, like an exclusive Valkyrie skin in Apex Legends, $200,000 in GTA cash every week you play GTA Online, and in Fall Guys, you get a special Burning Circuits costume for your bean through June 21st. Now, speaking of Fall Guys, the time has come to reveal a brand new costume coming to the game based on a legendary game franchise. Check it out.
Hey, we should pay our bills.
Here?
Yep.
What the?
A 2B outfit? 2B.
Tubi.
That's funny.
Oh my god.
Yoko Taro is pleased.
All right.
Boot it up.
fantastic. Disbelief.
Sick.
That Yo, Genshin funny. Impact.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. He's got, like, puppets.
The light in their vision will fade away.
Organizing the clash is my way of uncovering hidden talents, and hopefully this time, getting a vision to glow again. Your opponent is new to the clash, but he has quickly become the dark horse of the tournament. The vision is missing.
The sounds of nature turn into a clamor of noise during stormy weather. The winds are coming. Clouds hide. The birds come!
Play now.
Play now.
Play now.
So today we've announced games, a publisher, Prime Matter. So why not announce a developer too? And joining me now are Dave Anthony and Jason Blundell from the newly formed Deviation Games. We know you guys well from all your amazing work over the years at Treyarch and Call of Duty Black Ops. But what can we expect from your new studio, guys?
Well, thanks, Jeff. And look, Jason and I, we've been mates for donkey's years. And we're like an old married couple, Jeff. And we've been working together for decades. And we've worked on some huge franchises. You know the games. You know they've done well. And but we thought, you know, when you're working on those franchises, the long-established IPs, you're working within very, very tight constraints creatively about what you can do. So we thought, after all these years, you know, what if we deviated?
Yes.
So that's Deviation Games.
Okay.
So, Jeff, just trust me, all bets are off. From
day
one, we got complete financial security to work with creative freedom and time, not just to make a brand new IP, which is what we're doing, but a groundbreaking new IP with innovation at its very core. And the team at Deviation Games, the culture we have is really, really simple. It's, there's no place for ego. It's the best idea that always wins, and that's Deviation Games.
All right, well, big ideas from you guys, as we would expect. Now, I know it's very early, and there is nothing to show on the game today, but can you tell us a bit about what kind of game you're making? What can we expect?
Yeah, I mean, you're very right there, Jeff. Very early, but a lot of exciting stuff going on. So essentially, we spent the last year building the team, right? And so what we knew was we wanted to collect passionate, creative, collaborative people and bring them together kind of under one roof, and that's what Deviation Games is. So yeah, we don't have anything to show right now, but that collaboration, that imagination is going on, and we're going to have something that's going to I think leave an indelible mark in the industry when we come out.
All right. Well, with you guys involved, as I said, we're excited about it. There is one more piece of the puzzle, though, that you want to reveal today. And for that, let's take a look at this.
Exclusive studio?
Times PlayStation?
Okay, big news. The stage has changed. Blue of PlayStation. So you're partnering with PlayStation. What can you tell us about that partnership?
That's right, Jeff. And the partnership with PlayStation, it's all about quality. From soup to nuts, this project is all about quality. And our team of deviators that we have back in the studio, we're doing this for you. We are so proud of you. And the partnership with Sony, it's very, very simple. I mean, God, just look at the track record of consistency, of high-quality games that they do. It's hit after hit. It's award after award. And now we've been part of this process and we see how they do things. Yeah. It's really clear how they're managing to accomplish that. So we couldn't be more proud to expand PlayStation's portfolio, which we're going to do in a very, very significant way.
I mean, let's just face it, right? Sony rocks, and they get our kind of brand of crazy, so we're very happy with this partnership.
All right, so Deviation Games, PlayStation, brand new IP, a mega IP, it sounds like, coming in the future, and hopefully we'll see you guys again in the future to see more on what you're working on.
Could it be?
Thanks a lot, Jeff.
Awesome. All right, Dave, Jason, thank you very much, guys. All right, well, this year is the 30th anniversary of Sonic the Hedgehog, and later this month, we are honored to be premiering the full Sonic Symphony performance. But right now, here's the Philharmonic Orchestra in Prague performing the music of Sonic Unleashed.
Yo.
Sonic Unleashed?
Did Kyle do this?
Yeah. Did he request this?
Yeah. I'm pretty sure, Kyle.
Remaster, please. Song Unleashed remaster, please. Let's get that. Let's get that.
Was that one a good one?
Three-fourths of it are good. I like it. Three-fourths of it. I had a good time with it.
Here's a live orchestra playing Sonic
Honey, whoever had this on their bingo card, bet.
This would have paid out.
You win.
Bet's next year. Like, yeah. Which city's orchestra will Jeff have play?
Unexpected. Like, is Werehog Sonic joining Smash? Is that what we're leading to? Like,
oh my
dude,
god,
what is
so
happening?
Funny.
That would be insane.
Here's some Sonic Unleashed footage.
I mean, it's I'm loving it.
Yeah. No, not against. They're
just unexpected.
Unable to comprehend.
Yeah. Yeah. Show the Werehog.
Cute little artisanal light bulbs all over the place.
This feels wild, especially in this heat right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fever dream.
Yeah. I'm getting a little psychologically unhinged.
Yeah.
Elden Ring had to pull at the last minute, so they...
Can you imagine? What's as hype as Elden Ring? Get the proximity orchestra to play Sonic Unleashed.
30th anniversary type.
Okay. Full performance.
Not what I expected.
Back from blood.
Nice.
All right, beta, Sunday, beta. Warner Brothers Games and Turtle Rock minutes. Will be giving players a new look at the zombie multiplayer fun of Back for Blood. And right now, we've got a quick tease of a new boss and news on the beta coming later this summer.
Come on now. Come on now.
This summer.
Yeah. So excited.
Oh, yeah.
I like that guy.
Yeah.
Did you play the album?
I played it.
It was over so quickly, I missed it. I played it.
My boss was huge.
October 12th.
August
5th.
Open beta.
Okay. PvP showcase.
Whoa.
Ah.
PvP?
Well, Left 4 Dead has.
One of the things I'm most passionate about is getting you guys access to play more games at home. Last year, Steam and Xbox did incredible demo events around Summer Game Fest, and this year, Steam's Next Fest starts next Wednesday, and
nice.
Xbox is back again to do an ID at Xbox demo event, which I'm announcing right now. It starts on Tuesday, and it's completely free. No badges required. One of the games I'm most excited about in the lineup is Tunic from my fellow Canadian.
Tunic, dude!
To give you a little sneak peek of the brand new demo, which you can exclusively play on Xbox starting on Tuesday.
Tuesday, okay. Tunic, dude!
Hi, my name is Andrew Schuldice, and I'm working on Tunic, which is an isometric action adventure about a tiny fox in a big world where you explore the wilderness, fight monsters, and find secrets. I first started working on it about 6 years ago. It's been changing a lot over the years, but I'm really excited about where we've gotten to today. So in Tunic, you start the game and you are a little fox that's washed up on a beach, and you don't have a whole lot of context except for, you know, a lust for adventure, and you are going to wander off and maybe you're going to find a stick, and maybe if you venture a little bit further, maybe you're going to find a sword. And it's really about that sense of discovery, about wondering what's around the next corner. People have played the game at shows before, but we wanted to put together a brand new demo that was, you know, for the home audience. And so it's full of never before seen stuff, a brand new dungeon, a bunch of areas people haven't seen before.
Cool.
The so excited about it. Also is going to be one of the games in that.
Nice.
that, along with a lot of other awesome titles. Same, so check that out there, next week good. On Sweet. Xbox. Next up, stave off Ragnarok in this ancient Norse-inspired co-op action survival
RPG. Don't say
RPG.
That word.
Yeah, I know.
Careful,
I know.
Play don't solo. Say that word, Jeff.
A classic hack and slash forbidden gameplay word. Goes Viking in Norsefell's Tribes of Midgard, launching on PlayStation and PC July 27th. Here is the brand new trailer.
The giants have come to Midgard, and you have been chosen by the gods to protect this realm. But your first task is to find some new clothes that aren't as drafty. Your tribe's journey starts in the wilderness. Hunt down pets, gather rare resources, and
ARPG
explore
behind?
The untamed world.
Yeah, pretty much, right?
Once you've plundered all you can carry, return to your village and use those resources to forge Viking
RPG.
You must protect the seed of Yggdrasil at all costs, or this world and everything in it will be destroyed forever. So take heed. The Helthings rise when the sun sets.
Why Norse stuff
destroy
like
these dark spirits before they destroy the seed. Each victorious knight makes way for a new day. To venture into new lands, build to greater heights, and face fiercer creatures. And with great risk comes great rewards. But be careful, you're of little use to Midgard squashed by a troll. Craft legendary weapons, build deadly
that's
defenses,
cool. Yeah, that's
and
good.
Grow the strength of your yeah. tribe, because those giants are on their way. And it's time for us to end their
conquest.
Let's show them shit, our might is greater than their height. As the saying goes, Valhalla can wait.
Cool.
Yeah.
Cool. Intrigue. Sophia's texting me about it.
Nice, nice, dude. Let's play.
Who's ready for some Evil Dead?
Yeah! Yeah!
At TGA, and now it's time for an extended look at the gameplay. To tell
please
us more, let's turn it over to my friend, Tim Willits from
Sega. Anything Sabre. More oh, or less
hi,
is yeah.
great to see you. Today, we have some extended footage of the Evil
Hellraiser
Dead,
back there?
The game.
Yeah.
We are excited to show you this and to help me explain it, Bruce Campbell.
Top left.
Thank you.
Oh, Bruce Campbell. Showing it off. Sick.
Dude.
I'm so excited.
He looks so good.
Hola, cyber friends. I'm Bruce Campbell. You know me as Ash Williams, the dude who saved the world from evil. I'm here to bring you the lowdown on the upcoming Evil Dead the Game.
I mean, how do you not play Ash?
Yeah. Your friends will team up as classic well, Evil Dead heroes.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
You'll use savage finishing moves or tear evil a new one. Or, if you're not into the whole
does this
save
not look
the world
sick
thing,
awesome.
We have another option. You can play as the vile Kandarian demon itself.
Oh.
But who would want to do that? He'd be a dick.
Yeah.
With the power of possession in your arsenal, you'll scare those goody two-shoes to death. Literally, you can do that if you're a dick. Whether you choose the path of evil or righteousness, you'll be throwing down in places you've seen before. You'll collect pages of the Necronomicon, uncover Nobi's lost tapes, track down other legendary artifacts.
Tapes.
When you've grabbed enough, you'll use a spell to send the Kandarian son of a bitch back to the hellhole it came from.
Hell yeah. It's kind of
it's not reinventing the wheel.
Soon you'll experience the horror yourself, but for now I'll leave you with this thought. It was no accident that Ash always wore brown pants.
Playing that big
The actual action is tighter and more impactful than I was expecting. Like, great animation.
Dude! Good kill mechanics.
Nintendo Switch, really?
I know, right?
Switch Pro.
Oh, Switch Pro, not me!
Dude!
Yeah.
I'll spoil those good looks!
That this looks year. Fun,
yeah.
Dude.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. Now it's time for the grand finale to the show.
You bastard, Jeff.
Come back.
Work!
This is extremely special.
This is
today,
it.
I am so deeply honored to be given the opportunity to share this next game.
This
it comes
it.
From one of our industry's most acclaimed developers and a previous mm-hmm. Game of the Year winner mm-hmm. at the Game Awards.
Mm-hmm.
I want to personally thank this developer for believing in my vision of Summer Game Fest as a new way to bring all of us together for a cross-industry showcase and kick off the summer in the right way. So, without further ado,
Jeff.
Please sit back and enjoy this truly spectacular world Dude. Premiere. It is finally time.
That's it. It's it.
It has
it.
To be.
Oh my, this has to be.
It has to. If it's not it, he is in jail forever.
That's it.
Yeah, ah!
This is it.
This is definitely it.
The Tarnished will soon return. Guided by grace,
Massive.
Once lost. The
Ship
Golden
it.
Order is broken to its core.
Oh shit, there's your mount.
Oh.
That was an awesome summon. Holy shit.
Foul Tarnished. In search of the Elden Ring. Emboldened by the flame of ambition. Someone must extinguish thy flame.
They will fight. And they will die.
Whoa! Dude.
Wolfman, dude!
Those are your phantoms.
Oh,
shit!
I caught
dragon.
It, dude!
Wow. On a mount.
A champion or lord to be born.
Is that what you saw? Or is that? Oh, she's a boss.
Well. Lowly Tarnished, playing as a lord, I command thee.
Holy shit.
What a
scale. Finger spire.
It's all the games put together.
Brandish the Elden Ring.
That jump, dude. Jump attack.
For all of us.
Yup. Yup, please. Give us some
Give it a date. Give it a date. You. Please. I want to win that money.
Yes!
Yes!
Yes! Yes! That's like
yes!
7,000
yes! Yes!
bucks,
yes!
bitch!
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Woo!
Let's win!
Oh,
January! January!
Elden Ring.
Oh,
there
shit.
It is, dude.
January 21st, 2022 to next
oh my
gen,
God.
Current gen. It's so incredible, and I want to thank so much
good.
Miyazaki-san and the team at From for sharing that in-game look at
yeah,
Elden Ring. I hope you guys are happy. Oh my God, I'm free.
Out of prison. All right. That's going to do it for Summer Game Fest Kickoff Live. Thank
Dude.
You so much to all the colleagues.
St. Healy, dude.
It was all worth it. It
means so much to me. Summer Game Fest
game
continues
of the show.
All weekend with Netflix Geek Week.
We could go
Prime
home.
Matter tomorrow. Yeah. Ubisoft Forward on Saturday. And Xbox and Bethesda on Sunday. Square Enix as well. Head to summergamefest.com for the full and complete schedule. And this is
really many fucking environments.
So many enemies.
And a ton
so many
of
bosses.
Other amazing events that I'm fully supportive of. And I'm
and
very
you can
excited
launch up a mountain on your mount.
As, well. As for me, I'll see
it's
you
all
again on
to all
August
just the size
for
of
Gamescom
of
Open Night Live. And this December, I am so happy to say that the Game Awards will return as an in-person ceremony at the Microsoft Theater in Los Angeles. More details are coming later this summer. Thanks again for being a part of Summer Game Fest. We will see you tomorrow for more.
Jeff?
And stay tuned for the Day of the Devs
Actually,
with I Am 8-Bit and Double Fine right now. Good night, everybody.
Holy shit.
Keep your mics on. That's how they hear you talking.
That they showed way more than I was expecting.
Yeah, dude.
And that's
Elden
coming
Ring.
Way sooner than I expected.
Elden Ring, dude.
Wow.
Finally.
Did it live up? The meme is dead. To the unreachable expectations.
I think it surpassed.
Oh, it lived up.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Good
Holy
looking lore.
Shit.
My favorite shot was the, like, queen sitting in a chair.
Yes,
lady,
dude.
And then this, like, intense-looking knight standing next to her.
Well, dude, it has, awesome.
She...
it has elements of all of them. It had Dark Souls in there. It had Bloodborne in there. It had Sekiro in there. It had demons in there. It's crazy.
When she, like, stabbed the dude upward, that was... And there was, like, they showed it just very briefly, but there was, like, a spider made out of fingers.
And then that eyeball comes down.
I gotta use a bath mat for that.
Holy shit.
That was what was interesting is I don't know if this... I'd have to watch the trailer again. I don't know if this was a player character or an enemy, but there was a character that was, like, way more mobile. And so I wonder if just, like, how you move around will change depending on your
loadout. I mean, it looked like...
loadout.
Was there mounted combat?
There's Oh, yeah. for sure. Oh, yeah. Absolutely, yeah.
Wild.
Yeah. That was, like, one of the first things they showed.
Yeah.
Oh my!
I mean, you're gonna be fighting a dragon on your mount.
Oh my god.
Do you want to do post show or do you want to react to this?
What does the chat want?
Yeah, what does chat want?
Because this might be.
I mean, there's gonna be nothing. Psychonauts 2 in this probably. Would you be
Psychonauts
2
is hype. How do we not talk about Elden Ring?
Nothing matters now. Elden Ring. To Elden Ring.
Active version.
Okay,
trailer?
That's cool.
I can get that.
Elden Ring. I mean, we should probably keep this going a little.
Okay.
Axiom Verge 2, that's new stuff.
Metal Slug Tactics.
Let us not forget Metal Slug
Game
Tactics.
Of the show.
Yeah.
Yo, I gotta say, though, Evil Dead looks hot.
Yes!
Hello,
look at
I'm Tom Happ.
Visually,
I'm really excited
play,
to share with you some
about
new details
good,
about
man.
Axiom Verge 2.
My only concern is that just Ash with the chainsaw kills look way more fun than anyone else.
Dude, there were some good stabbings, though, with the other characters. I felt like they were getting their due.
When was the release date on
January 20th.
Axiom Verge 2 plays a bit different from the original.
I don't think
they
did. I don't remember a date.
Trace used a projectile-based weapon in the first game. Indra's combat style is primarily.
I mean, we can definitely just rewatch it if you want to do that instead of this. Although Axiom Verge 2
looks cool. Somebody join.
I'm turning it down.
I can turn down my headphones.
Brute strength isn't Indra's primary weapon. It is a contest of mind over matter.
So we just have to figure out which one I am.
Indra's ability to hack enemies and alter.
Nothing better than like big open world combined with like dark, dank interior intimacy, dude. That's what that trailer showed me.
You know, it's like watching a trailer where everything is max capacity of quality. Everything.
Yeah, dude.
Everything. No ifs or and or buts.
But it didn't seem like it lost any of the, like, from
Oh, of course, no.
It legit looked like open world, like you were saying.
It's an open world Dark Souls.
Soul Sicker.
Yeah.
Only to get stuck at a boss they just couldn't get past. And that ends the game experience for them.
Super bad. Tough act to follow.
Such a tough follow.
For players out there who love a good boss fight,
I'd play
this.
Yeah.
Do you play for some red?
No. Always wanted to.
I feel like our biggest reactions were to Metal Slug Tactics.
Dude, Metal Slug Tactics looks so rad.
So good looking.
Holy shit, that game looks sick.
Yep.
What an unexpected play.
I remember Axiom Verge 1 I liked, except the there were like a lot of really annoying audio.
And I'm looking forward to seeing everyone discover all of the
lots of little bleeps and bloops that were making me annoyed.
Bleeps and bloops.
Bleeps and bloops. Top 10 bleeps and bloops.
Come on.
Still not overplayed.
Same.
Oh, and one more thing.
Date?
In addition to PC and Switch. We're excited to announce Axiom Verge 2 is also coming to PlayStation 4 and 5.
That's a victory.
I just saw it even with this next game. It's so delightful. It's pure glee in a game brought to you by the gang at something we made out of Sweden. It's called Toem. It has the best art style and is just pure happiness. Try not to smile.
Hello.
Hey, Sam.
My name is Nicholas.
And I'm Lucas.
And we are Something We Made. And we're excited today to show our
It is so hot.
Go take a second out there. It's a lot cooler.
I need a sec.
Sorry, chat. It's really hot in here.
Yeah.
Toem.
Doing our best. Oh, this looks cool.
Oh. You play as an amateur photographer on a journey to see the magical phenomenon
Look at
known
this.
As Toem.
We'll play.
Yeah, I can see blood into this.
But first, you need to get there by bus. And to earn your bus rides, you need to help the various quirky characters found in the different regions.
Thank you, chat, for all those links to Elden Ring trailer.
Oh my god, yeah, thank you, chat.
I see 4K. If you got the 8K link, I'll take that one.
Oh my god. Fantastic photo.
Fantastic.
The Photographing Guild will challenge your
photographing
skills with specific challenges.
Cute.
As you stroll along various locales, you'll run into puzzles that will have you using different tools.
Seagull, dude. There's a bird.
There's a bird living in there. Little photography puzzles.
Yeah, that's fun.
There's a lot to see and photograph in Toem.
Nice.
Friends to meet along the way.
Oh, skeleton man.
What kind of creature are you?
We ourselves are based in a super small town called Palsam, which is pretty calm and tranquil. We want
That's
to
great.
Try to capture that inside the game.
to 30 degrees hotter. You feel at peace.
Yeah, dude.
And
what does the temperature stay on that thing?
Hopefully, you have a great time playing Toem, and we can't wait to see your photos.
It is 84 degrees in this room.
84 that feels like 90.
Yeah, oh, well, under the lights, I'm sure it's hotter.
Don't forget to wish list on Steam.
That's what he said.
I like that Link's Awakening artwork they have in the
background.
Our next
game pits you against your friends to run the fastest time through a series of dungeons. This is Phantom Abyss from Team Weeby and Devolver Digital.
Hi, I'm Ben Marinen from Team Weeby, and I'm the lead designer on Phantom Abyss.
Have they rewatched the Elden Ring trailer?
Not yet.
Okay.
Not yet.
Damiani's getting the 8K version.
8K!
Yeah. Sense Forgers.
In Phantom Abyss,
I've seen
the goal is to grab a relic buried deep within a procedurally generated
Legends
temple.
Of the Hidden Temple?
However, you only get one shot, and if you die, you never get to try that temple again.
Fun.
Phantom Abyss is an asynchronous multiplayer game, where temples are filled with the Phantoms, previous players who tried a temple before you and died. Eventually, when someone claims the relic,
the
they'll seal up that temple,
this
meaning
looks
only
really
one
fun.
Person in the world will ever beat a specific temple.
I definitely want to try this.
Only one person in the world beats every specific temple. That's cool. Because they're all procedural.
Players
all
are equipped with a whip, which they can use to climb obstacles and interact with the world around them.
It's too bad the bet wasn't Will-A-Whip-Crack.
Will-A-Whip-Crack.
Yeah.
Those other guys are definitely dressed
Phantoms
in
also interact with
Indiana
the world,
Jones cosplay.
Which can be used both to your advantage and disadvantage.
Yo, the Elden Ring date, though.
Yeah.
Paying off.
Yep.
$9,000, baby, or something like that.
Eiley, you're on my team, right?
As players delve deeper into a temple, they become hunted by that temple's guardian. Guardians are incredibly powerful beings that will stop at nothing to prevent you from claiming a role.
Okay.
Wait, there's four of you on a team? Because I'm the captain.
Well, Huber's the captain.
Oh, right. That's right.
Team Huber. Chad, if you don't know what we're talking about, we did a betting special the other day.
If you don't know what we're talking about, get out.
There are many different types of whips that players can use in the game, which have their own strengths and weaknesses. You can also spend coins during a run to receive powerful blessings.
I had to believe. You've got to believe.
The game's scheduled to be entering early access on Steam very soon. And I can't wait for everyone to enter this world as they start making phantoms and claiming relics. I hope you enjoy
it. That's cool.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Neat concept.
That was 8 with crack.
That was. That was not counted. It was not Indiana Jones, though.
Not Indiana Jones. This game heavily inspired by Indiana Jones, I would say.
Oh, yes.
Our next title is a heartwarming tale of fruits, fungi, and frogs. It's all about a little grape who is tasked with caretaking their island home and protecting it from invasive rot. Much like my own gardening experience out here, this is a game of questing, combat, cultivation, and building a community of pals. This is Garden Story.
Garden Story. Did you have enough time to read that?
No. Go back. Okay.
Yeah. All right.
Kristen is already wishlisting this.
Yeah.
100%.
Yep.
Already wishlisted.
Yep.
You play as a great
Tell me I'm
dude.
Wrong, Kristen.
This looks lovely.
Join us for a quick tune.
Grape with a sword.
Yeah,
that's what I'm talking about.
dangerous choice.
For a great.
Yeah.
Dude, I want to push this.
This music's great, man.
Yeah, it's really, really chill.
Okay,
chill.
It's gonna. Oh. Man, did you play CrossCode?
I got to play CrossCode.
Yeah, you would love that one.
Yeah, you got
sure.
That.
That's way more
it's on Switch, finally. Weird, like, tape distortion they have on this one. That little frog boy, dude.
Garden Story.
Hey everyone, my name's Will Lewis. I'm a co-founder of Rose City Games, and we are publishing Garden Story.
That's a real beard.
That is
Garden Story is being developed by our friend Pico Graham with music
like
by our
years.
Friend Graham Nesbitt.
Yeah,
he was born with that beard.
That might be maximum length. You know?
Yeah, that's
like stops
four.
At a certain point. Did you know that it's incredibly
that
hot
beard
in
here? Some marinara sauce.
Combat.
Oh my god. Yeah.
Management.
It's the worst. I gotta get a
the
water.
Worst feeling.
Where you're constantly learning about new characters and about parts of the island that you're kind of helping put back together.
Woody.
Moving between the seasonal villages of your island, you take on a lot of requests and challenges to help your community and discover a history between the characters and what's been going on there recently.
Whoa, look at that guy on the right.
Yeah.
There's this omnipresent, mysterious enemy called the Rot that's been popping up in force. And it's your job as the island's
guardian. Yo, what was the dynamicism? Was
it
dynamism?
Yeah,
dynamism.
We gotta
have a dynamism
of E3.
Yep. Next year.
Will it be said one more time?
Yes.
Yeah, one more time.
Okay.
Okay.
It's so fun to explore the really charming.
That's like a EA Ubisoft thing.
Yes, absolutely.
EA Ubisoft. Perfect. Perfect bet.
Clay is with a glass of lemonade.
Yep.
Ice or no
outside
ice?
On a hammock.
Ice.
There's really just a lot
to
discover.
Not too much,
though.
A lot of mystery mixed in with the gameplay, and
refills
a lot of
or
really
no
great
refills?
Atmosphere with how
like,
the
do you have
art
the
is. Playing this? This is, yeah,
you got
your
picture.
Yeah. Yeah. Picture.
Of course.
Yeah,
excellent.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Of course.
Need a slight breeze. Are you going to eat grapes while you play it, or is that
ooh,
too dark?
No, that's too
that'll
dark.
Freak me out.
Too
yeah.
Dark.
Inspiration with that chilled
too
out.
Maybe like some
bright
orange slices.
Music style is
so if I was an orange in your village, you're like, oh, no.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It's really easy to jump in and feel good
does
about
anybody
living in the world.
Have any orange slices?
Maybe play it safe. Some flaming hot
the art
lime
animation
cheetahs.
Music effects
yeah.
Those
are my all-time favorite
really really new while making sure that
just
you
had them last week
comfortable in the game and feel right at home despite all the
I
new challenges in front of little garden.
I didn't know there were
jalapeno cheetos.
I didn't know there were jalapeno.
Amazing.
I bet I would like it.
We can't wait to see you in the Grove when
dude.
Garden Story comes out this summer.
I'll see you in the Grove.
Yep.
I'll be
Kristen's
there.
Already in the Grove.
Yeah.
Prove me wrong.
I need to know. Dude. I need to know.
Whether you've been trying to perfect sourdough or just get through all the piles of panic-bought pasta you've accumulated, quite a few of us have spent a bit of time in the kitchen this past year. This next game aims to take your real-life cooking abilities to the next level, whether you're a seasoned chef or a culinary catastrophe. It's a super chill cooking sim that specifically explores
cooking
the fascinating
sim.
World of Philippine, Korean, and Japanese cuisines. Sit back and allow us
awesome.
To nourish your senses. This is Soup Pot.
I'm Gwen Foster from Chicken Club, and we're a collective of game developers making a game called Soup Pot.
I'm so in.
Whoa.
I'm so in.
Dude, kind of giving me a Shenmue vibe, and I'm here for it.
Thank you. cooking is the best.
Soup Pot is a chaotic and chill cooking simulator.
Chaotic and chill.
It allows players to discover more than 100 different recipes from different regions. All of which can be accessed in a social media app called Cookbook.
Teka lang, where's my recipe? Recipe, take me back my energy. Energy, ito yung bawang na I cannot see. I cannot see, manghalo to sa delicacy. Delicacy.
What makes our game unique is that there are no fail states. We wanted players to be able to learn and fail and have fun with cooking. Cooking has always been part of many games, but has rarely been the central mechanic. For Soup Pot, we work with chefs and cooks to make sure that the recipes in-game you could also make in real life. For the first time, we are showing that Soup Pot is just not limited to dishes that can be made with cooking pots. You can also grill and skewer.
Spangle barbecue. What are we drinking with this one, man?
Ooh, this one?
This is a tricky one.
Sapporo. That's what I'm having.
Yeah.
Sapporo.
Craft beer. Yeah.
At Chicken
what
Club,
is that?
Somehow getting a draft like beer at home.
Cooking simulator.
BBI.
Chilled glass.
Yep.
Chilled glass.
Chilled glass. Great compromise there.
Yeah.
We hope that our game makes you love cooking just as much as we do.
Very end.
So we'll watch Day of the Devs and then do a post show, watch the Elden Ring trailer like 7 times. And that'll
next
be that
comes
for today's
from Glitchy Studio in France. This is a musical story. It's a beautiful adventure game that trades in dialogue
like
trees for rhythm-based gameplay.
Not that long, like 20, 30 more.
Hello
minutes.
Everyone. Cool. I'm Charles Bardin, game designer and co-composer at the French video game company Glitchy Studio. And the game we're going to show you today is called A Musical Story.
It's getting heavy.
Yep.
Did we make it? Where am I? Wait, who am I? Am I dreaming? I can hear music. Yeah, I know this. This is my band. This is our music. This was our dream.
In a musical story, you play music to unlock memories. The game is set against a 70s backdrop with influences from Pink Floyd, Led Zeppelin, or Jimi Hendrix, and tells the story of Gabriel, a young musician trying to come to terms with his situation through the connections to his musical memory. Gabriel and his friends decide to participate in the legendary Pinewood Festival. Gabriel will experience friendship, love, but also very hard times as he struggles with addiction.
Shit.
Oh, dude. Shit.
Shit, dude.
The entire story is told without using a single word. The gameplay is very different from any musical game you know, as there's no visual playhead on screen. Everything is based on your ability to listen to the music and understand it, making it a very organic and rewarding experience.
Trust in the players.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's difficult.
Getting the latency correct sounds difficult for the dev. Because that's like devastating.
We and our friends at Digirati have put hearts and souls searching for the best possible balance between fun gameplay mechanics and a meaningful and soulful story.
And a devastating story.
We really hope you'll enjoy the game when it releases later this year on Nintendo Switch, PlayStation, Xbox, iOS, and PC. And we are super excited to tell you that a free demo is available to download on Steam right now.
Cool. Nice.
Two Shadow Drops.
Yeah. What was the Shadow Drop during PlayStation? Was it, or during Sony? Or during... Huh? Keeley-thon?
Yeah, I forget what it was.
Yeah,
it was something for PlayStation.
It was the paint game.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
That looks really cool, actually, that paint game.
Video games are such a beautiful medium because you can literally make them out of anything. Developer Kong Orange, who made the criminally underrated Felix the Reaper, are back
exactly
with
the same
a painstakingly
Jack,
nuanced and super hyper detailed
so really
stop motion experience called Vocabulantis. And while stop motion is nothing new to games, their POV and perspective here is something really special.
Yeah, demos don't count.
It's still
a few years out, but we're pretty pumped.
Was not. Because the release date was already announced.
My name is Johan Huttinger, and I'm the stop motion part of Vocabulantis.
Actually,
they're robbing us.
Yeah.
Stop motion?
Yeah.
I'll need a word with the word Fuhrer. His stupid interjection army is destroying Vocabulantis and my speaker scope. What did my speaker scope ever do to? Wait.
Dude,
the elevator is coming.
Stop motion since I was a child, and I do it
Whoa.
Professionally now. But ever since The Neverhood came out in the 90s, I've dreamt of making a stop motion animated video game.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. So impressive.
Almost killed that guy.
Yeah.
Careful.
But where you can control the characters, they can run and they can jump and they
Reminds
can grab onto
the,
things.
Like Machinarium, what was that company called? Aminata?
Yeah.
But then it's fully stop motion animated.
Yeah.
Where the animator moves the puppet.
That's cool though.
And you take a photo and the animator
cool.
moves the puppet again. But to make it more interesting, we do it a little bit different.
Painstaking.
So the animator moves the puppet and we take the photo. So as you can see, each pose of the puppet is photographed several times with different light directions. And out of them, we can combine those photos into a normal map. The character
Crazy.
Running around in the 3D engine
yep.
will have light information
Technology.
Based on real light.
That's wild.
Oh, you decided to come back? Ethan, boy of no use.
That's why I'm always offended when people say, games are not the best they've ever been in the world, because we get shit like
I
this
now.
Daily.
But listen,
look at this thing.
No, I need your help. See that handle up there? Go pull it. If you have any questions, speak now. I thought so. Clever.
We can't talk.
Just so incredible.
Really integrates into the handmade sets that are photogrammetried in our photogrammetry scanner over here. Let me show you.
Wait, they
so
made the
that
sets
motion
for
control
real?
That controls the camera back there, and then the same motion control controls the objects, and the camera back there takes from
That's
each
nuts.
Position of the camera. It's around 100 photos. The software turns it into a mesh, and then we use that in the game engine.
Man.
We want it to look like a stop-motion film, but still we can make all the levels fun to play and interesting to play.
I like the little animation telling you how to do it. Well, I thought it would be on the wall.
Thank you so much for checking Vocabulantis out. I hope you liked what you see. We are
Definitely.
Looking forward to show you more.
wish list right.
Woof.
Oh. Ow.
Okay, yes, yes, get up now. Now show that you are worth some use at least.
Oh, man.
Just killer
at the end of the trailer.
Yeah,
like,
good lord.
Having been pretty much rooted to the spot for over a year now, the desire to jump in the car, drive off into the sunset, and never look back is strong in all of us.
Please,
this next game,
game
from the creator in the car,
the
drive off into the
one?
Sunset, and
the
never look
post
back,
the one
is strong
trip
in
car
all
game.
Of us. This next game
yes!
is from the creator.
Oh no.
Major buckle.
Full buckle.
Dude, I want to see that game so badly.
Ground control to major buckle.
Not on our end, it looks like.
For once.
Uh-oh.
For once.
F.
F's in the chat.
Rip.
What did you do?
It was me.
F's in their chat, too.
F's in their chats. Rips, F's.
Elden Ring.
All right. Elden
yeah,
Ring.
The,
frame by frame.
Their chat's going crazy. Yeah.
Okay.
Well,
I think it was that cool.
No, the Twitch channel is like having their issues.
Six is a unique adventure.
Yes, yes.
Procedural generation
yes,
narrative
dude.
In a way that has almost never
Road
been
96.
Seen. You start playing as a teenager that wants to escape its country in
there's
the brick of turmoil
like too,
and
there
reach
are, like,
the border,
three
which is
like, road
thousands
trip
of
games
miles away in the mountains.
So
feels like
economy.
Oh yeah, you're right. Firewatch. Graphical stuff.
I don't know if like 30
as
you hours
try
on
to get closer to the border, you will come across different
Walk
characters,
the dinosaur?
Each of them with their unique backgrounds, storylines, and very strong personalities.
Now you get out of the car.
Yeah.
That's, mm-hmm.
yeah.
Yeah.
Just tuck and roll.
Tuck
I
and roll, dude. Tuck and roll whatever happens.
Before we get
Love
much
this.
Further, I should let you know that I have some anger management issues.
Get what? Out!
So, get where are we
car.
Headed today with Happy Taxi?
Tom Waits ass creepazoid up
then
here
just
today.
North it is. Now sit
Tuck
back and enjoy
roll.
Your ride with Happy Taxi.
By making those decisions along the way, you start tracing your own path to the border, and that path will be different
that other one had, like,
for
a bunch
each
of people in a
player.
Yeah.
Bus, right? In
yeah.
a van?
I saw you yeah. looking
was that the
max.
One you were thinking of?
Yep. This one, though, too, dude.
Yeah,
it's
this
super.
One looks good.
Are you a fan of dinosaurs? I won't
okay,
get
I'm,
angry
this,
if
I'm
you
so
aren't.
Into this. Who's not a fan of dinosaurs?
But it's a trap.
It's a trap. He's gonna get angry.
What?
You will discover personalities of this country inhabitants, their backgrounds. Yes.
Is he holding you at gunpoint?
Yeah. Dude. Don't disrespect dinosaurs
trauma.
Around him.
And progressively, by all the decisions, you may even change the country.
Guess you forgot I had a gun. Now, get in your filthy van and find me a light.
I'm Wacky Goodman. I play Jared and many other characters on the Road 96.
I feel like having a smoke.
A lot of bad things happened in his life. He's really bitter.
Economy.
And he's
official.
Kind of taken his revenge out on everyone else.
Dude.
Whoa. Steal his cab.
Yeah.
His gun.
Depending on your tastes, the destination, and most importantly, the path to the destination will vary from
cool
thousands
concept.
Of
wow.
possibilities.
They helped me.
That's cool.
Played games with me. They stole my money. And they made me realize that I have to come back home to make my own way,
yeah.
to help the brigades.
Look at the number, it's like the possibility.
Where am I? Road 13, Road 42, Road 67, Road 96.
That looks cool, dude.
Yes.
140,000 different.
No date.
While it's still early, developer Strafon has created something really special and unique with the Wandering Village. On paper, it's a town building sim. You go about your business, you build up your population, erect buildings, mine for resources. But
you're running the show.
Switch over.
How was this? I think these have been in there since before pandemic.
Is that right?
Village. On paper, it's a town building sim.
He said village.
You go about your business, you build up your population, erect buildings, mine for resources. But it has a really rad twist.
Hello, everybody. We're Claudia Beck.
Hi.
And Philomena Schwab from Strafon Studio. And we're here today to present to you our upcoming game, The Wandering Village, a city building simulation game on the back of a giant wandering creature.
Like Mortal Engines.
Mortal Engines had potential. That movie was
FX
not
the book.
Great.
A lot.
Cool concept, though.
Yeah.
This deeply style. Strange concept. Yeah, I'm so into this.
Wood, please.
More wood is
good. I was thinking Xenoblade now. Something like this.
What about Cronus, the God of War?
Our studio is known for doing science-based games, and this one is based in biology and ecology.
Such dynamism.
Hers can anger the animal?
Next E3, dude. Dynamism bet, no question.
Just if the word appears?
Yeah. Will it appear once? Next E3.
Visually, the game is inspired by Möbius and Studio Ghibli, and musically, it's influenced by various forms of folkloric music from all around the world. Your people will be escaping and seeking shelter from a toxic fungus.
Toxic fungus.
Love a good toxic fungus, dude.
And they will find it on this giant animal they call Umbu.
Yo, annihilation.
Yeah.
Traveling like from biome to biome, bringing new opportunities, but also new challenges.
Kind of depends on your point of view, I guess. How resistant to change.
And you're going to be communicating with the Umbu to create and build on your symbiotic relationship.
If you build this specific building,
feel that
or tower, near the animal's head, so it will be able to hear you, you then get this additional view of zooming out to the animal and giving it different commands. Such as run or lay down.
Video games are the best.
That's awesome.
But the Umbu is still a wild creature, and so it may decide to listen to you, but sometimes it won't, depending on mood and your relationship with the animal.
Bonds.
We are big fans of city builders and colony sim games in general.
Don't Starve,
do Black
style?
And White, yeah. The Settlers, Rimworld, and Banished, and all of them inspired us. If I have to choose two games that are most similar to ours, it would be Frostpunk and Airborne Kingdom, because they not only share our genre, but they also have a unique setting and a limited building space.
I was thinking of Airborne Kingdom. So what they're saying is this game is hard. Frostpunk is very hard. Airborne Kingdom is not quite
We're
as
hoping
hard
to release The Wandering Village on Steam Early Access later this year in Q4. So if you liked what you saw, please consider to leave us a wishlist. And if you want to stay up to date with the development of the game, come join us on Discord. Thanks
please
for your attention.
To leave us
See you next time.
Wish list.
Bye.
Bye.
This game looks good.
Yeah.
Wait, every game that they've shown has been kind of bad.
Yeah. Yeah, not.
I feel like we haven't seen anything where we're like,
Yeah.
There were a few in the Keeley Fest that I was like, yeah, alright, but like, nothing was like outright. Honestly, though, I've probably just forgotten. Elden Ring kind of wiped my mind of everything.
It's the bombardment, too.
Yeah.
I'm just like, game.
Just remembering the names is different.
Yeah, Blood's been keeping notes.
I realized, like, right at the end that I was like, none of us has been writing anything down.
Halfway next through. Up is Unbeatable from D-Cell Games, just coming off a super successful Kickstarter campaign.
Shaking off the rust, the E3 rust.
Oddly, it's another beautiful narrative adventure game with rhythm mechanics, but much different than a musical story. So please enjoy.
I'm Andrew Tsai.
I'm TJ Maddox.
I'm Rachel Lake.
I'm Vasily Nikolaev.
I'm Jeffrey.
I'm RJ Lake.
And we are D-Cell Games. We're making Unbeatable,
an anime-inspired rhythm adventure game where music is illegal.
And you do crime.
Yeah. Directly at that.
Yeah, that was intense.
Boom. Anime?
Heads snapped.
Yeah.
Anime games?
Oh, dude.
Cheaper bait right there.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
This looks like some new stuff.
Really? Yeah, dude.
Here's the anime intro.
Yes.
Are rhythm games back?
The basic setup
this
is simple.
This is how I feel on the inside.
You have two buttons. One button for
that's
up.
That's how I felt when I watched
Scott for down.
I was like, they did it.
That framework powers everything, from fighting off monsters during a rock concert, to winning an eating competition, to playing darts.
In between that, you're going to be exploring the city, avoiding the authorities, talking to locals, finding hidden secrets, and, of course, planning out your illegal underground concerts.
In this early section of the game, Beat, that's the girl with the pink hair, and her three bandmates just barely managed a daring escape from the local police.
Yeah, like, food,
they find themselves washed up on a beach on the outskirts of the city, and now need to scope out a venue and figure out where they're going to lie low and practice.
Before you go on for the big show, you're going to be finalizing the songs that you're playing.
The songs you have access to here are all based on what Beat and the band have managed to write, which is influenced by all of your decisions.
Yeah, dude.
Unbeatable is a synthesis of everything we love about our favorite games with the memories that we have watching bootleg anime as kids. With Unbeatable, we're telling a multi-generational story about nostalgia and the ways that nostalgia objects change when viewed with different contexts. We're enormously excited for everyone to check it out when it's done. Since that will be a bit, why not download our free demo, Unbeatable White Label, right now?
Free demo!
It will let you play through a dozen songs already.
Thank you from everybody.
Yeah, different title, so it counts, right?
What demo's kind of real.
But it's called White Label, so it's like a mini different game.
Our pals at Devolver Digital are back with developer Acid Nerve for Death's Door. This is the team behind Titan Souls, so if you're a fan of super challenging combat, tight boss battles, and birds with swords, you're going to dig this one.
Hi, I'm David Fenn. I'm a producer and designer at Acid Nerve, and we're working on a game called Death's Door.
Into this music.
Into this game.
Have you seen this before?
This is awesome.
A Crow Soul?
Yeah.
It's a soul. Crow Soul Souls?
Weirdly reminds me of Palmer.
Yeah.
It's a fantasy action-adventure set in a strange world where nothing naturally dies anymore. and this group of lazy office worker crows are in charge of maintaining some sense of order. You play as one of the crows, and your job is to venture into the outside world and reap the souls of the dead.
Seems cool.
It's just crazy to think how much Dark Souls has inspired you.
Yeah.
Like the
yeah.
breadth of
yeah.
it.
Yeah. Dark Souls and Zelda are like yeah. every game.
Yeah. Every game. Seriously.
Combat focuses cool on face. Intense, fast-paced brawls, where mistakes are punished and skill is rewarded.
TV. Yeah.
It's a nod.
Our background is in tight, oh, 2D yeah. pixel art action, and we've been careful to maintain the responsiveness of this style. The world is fully explorable and it's entirely handcrafted. All of the characters and enemies that you meet
music's
have memorable twisted
vibe,
designs
right?
as well.
I like this piano.
Death's Door has plenty of high octane action, but it's equally about discovering the secrets of its unique setting and unraveling its mysterious story. The structure and the scope of the gameplay most closely match one of our oldest
what?
Inspirations, The Legend of Zelda.
Yeah, it's a good one.
Get me all over this thing.
Almost missed.
I kind of like when there's that idea.
You yeah. have a grim job to do, but you'll also bring hope to the weird and wonderful residents who are trying to make their way
Side
to this
quest.
Strange
oh,
place.
You.
The setting yeah. and the circumstances are bleak, but the moment-to-moment interactions
weird,
have touches of humor and positivity. It's this juxtaposition that we find so compelling, and we really hope that you do as well. If so, you can look forward to playing Death's Door when it comes out this summer. Thanks very much.
Soon.
Summer. We'll play.
It's going to be a summer of
games. Stack it up.
Yeah.
Summer of games. Like a fest, almost.
Thought I would mix it up this summer and play some
games. Oh, okay.
Damn, dude.
Full.
You've earned it, Ben.
You've earned it.
Play some games, dude. Play some games, Ben. Yeah, like, cut loose.
Yeah.
Oh!
Alexander.
My late headphones.
Interesting. Probably just...
Oh, that's back.
We're okay, back, but
tight.
Nobody panic.
Oh, he's gone again.
Death's Door.
Maybe that connection is just a little...
Oh, wait, no, it's Huber.
Wait, I think I'm...
Huber's in
Huber,
control.
Don't put your chairs on
Classic.
The cables.
Over the last generation of games, we've seen such
Classic.
Crazy leaps in animation.
It's good
but
to be back.
We
should wrangle the cables. Good to be back with the crew.
Behind the Frame is a perfect example.
Yeah.
It's a narrative-focused
it's like we never
experience
missed
from a developer
beat.
Out of Taiwan called Silver.
I'm really glad we're watching this,
though. Yeah, this is super
Also, Huber has it during playtests. It's been known
We could still watch the Elden Ring trailer later, too.
It exists now.
It exists.
I know.
I don't get it.
It's just I'm committed to this.
Fashion
point.
Souls.
Hey
Fashion
guys,
souls.
I'm Wei Chen Lin.
Hi.
We're a Silver Lining studio located in Taiwan. Today we're going to show you a little bit of our game, Behind the Frame.
Behind the Frame.
Did he have a little arcade cabinet tattoo?
I don't
that'd
know.
That'd be a cool
That's
tattoo.
Cool.
Oh. I heard Damiani in the other room go, yeah. Whoa. Dude, I love this. So much
Whoa.
Ghibli in this.
Yeah.
Hmm.
This is like
this
the
is
most
fantastic.
Ghibli.
So much Ghibli.
Yeah.
So all we need now is Ghibli souls.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Playing this
in the early morning hours with a fresh cup of coffee. Mm-hmm.
Fresh cup
behind
of
the
coffee.
Frame is a puzzle-solving story-oriented.
The Game Awards logo on the bottom corner.
The story is about a painter who is chasing a lifelong dream.
Oh, it's a professional artist. Dark Roast.
All right.
This is fantastic.
We really want to make the game feel like anime film. So we use our anime style to differentiate the objects from backgrounds.
It's the meta.
After I check the New York Times.
This feels like the lo-fi chill beats to study.
Yes,
too,
yes,
but
yes.
A game.
Yeah.
Gameplay is in first-person perspective.
Okay.
With several cutscenes.
Okay. Just so beautiful.
Oh my god, yeah, this is great. Everyone's a painter in this reality?
Silent film?
Yeah, jolliest like vibes. Dude,
she got Donald old.
Getting like, getting this grizzled old man to like open up emotionally.
Yes!
Who are you? Answer me!
He's lost people.
Yeah.
Yep.
That was cool.
Specifically on the seed.
Wow.
Yes.
What made you want to be a wiki?
Old man's old cat.
I love this.
But she later on will found out her apartment has some secrets that she didn't know of.
Secrets?
Hey.
Like, little reckless. Little reckless work there.
Everyone's a critic.
True.
Like I mentioned before, we want this game to have anime and whimsical feels. So we chose hand-paint 2D panorama environments instead of building a 3D model.
That's in her apartment now.
Damiani's doing it, dude.
Yeah.
Damiani, how you holding up?
Yeah.
Oh, there he goes! Okay. Oh, he made it.
Good.
He made it.
The story is really about love,
he's
life,
so chunky,
and how to preserve memories.
See, he's got tenderness.
Are you just like creeping on this the whole game?
Calling it now, old man contender for character of the year.
Yeah. Oh yeah, it's like Rear Window.
Yeah,
we are really excited to be part of Date of Death. Thank you guys.
Love
Very
it.
Impressive.
Great, love though. This game.
Yeah.
What's it called? Oh yeah, Behind the Frame.
Life.
Life, the finest scenery.
We've always
found
wow. like the mission of Day of the Dead
gonna make
to
me cry.
Take beyond our own bandwidth. So we always take a turn to spotlight organizations around the world that are doing good by the gaming community. One of those is Asobu. They're based in Tokyo, and they're helping indie devs in Japan make their dream
like
projects.
Old
just like old times.
Just miss every time.
Hi everyone, my name is Anne and I'm the manager of Asobu, a community hub for indie creators here in Tokyo.
Cool. Asobu っていうのは何なのか? Asobu のコンセプト自体はコミュニティを作っていく、コミュニティを醸成していくということです。今具体的にどういう活動をしているかというと、渋谷にコミュニティスペースを運営して、そこをベースとして活動をしているメンバーの方々が主にゲーム制作を活動をしています。
Here at Asobu, we are all about helping Japanese creators.
Jimmy Stewart's skin.
We're trying to build a community
nobody.
Where they can learn from each other, find sure. friends, collaborators, promote their project by connecting them with other awesome indie communities
parts,
all over the world or athletes, like today, the Day of the Dev.
すごくいろんな人々にとってはゲームを作るということがどういうことなのか割と分かりづらいことなのです。それをゲーム作りはこういう人々がやっていて、こういうプロセスでこういうふうにやってる。そしてこういう成功を収めることができる。そういうことを広くいろんな人に伝えていきたいと思っています。
Yo, Gundam, yeah.
You're just an anime! Yeah.
Japan,
dude.
But back to the end point on promoting Japanese indies. Here is a few games to keep an eye on. Elec-Head is a unique 2D puzzle platformer being solo developed by the Yun creator Namatagashi.
That sound.
Oh, fun.
You play as a tiny robot, trying to bring back the light to the world. Electricity runs through everything you touch.
How
any
do you
place
know?
You trust your robot.
Yeah.
You know what?
I was wondering the same thing.
Oh, that's cool.
Oh, that is cool.
Smart. Eric
Head is due out on Steam and itch.io later this year.
Bloodworth joint.
Yeah.
Heard him laughing.
That looks so cool.
He loves it. It's already got the code.
Cool. Alright.
Demolition Robots KK, put you in control of a giant robot, how to make all the cash you can by destroying as many buildings as possible. Developed by Takahashi Studio, this is multiplayer mayhem with a twist.
Marty.
Twitch viewers can influence the game by choosing items or actions on screen.
Trap.
Demolition Robots KK is planned for PC and console release later this year.
Walk.
The Pantera game we've all been waiting for.
Dude, when is the damn...
Oh, oh my yeah. god!
This,
is a survival
this looks
horror
sick!
From Kazuya.
Jeez. That is actually terrifying.
Yeah.
It all takes place at dusk in an unnamed Japanese suburb.
Dude!
Yo, I'm uncomfortable.
What a cool
Maybe
style.
This. But this
you
looks
control
sick.
A defenseless schoolgirl trying to return home before dark.
Ah! Oh my god, dude!
Holy
this
shit.
Is
Yo,
a stream, dude.
Drink nothing.
Yeah,
when you
no,
play
no,
this game.
Yeah.
No. No beverage.
Yeah. Bring a bucket.
Oh!
Look at that thing! Murder. Whoa!
Kazumi
Love the style.
Yeah.
Walk as a Kickstarter later this year.
Launch
and that's all for today. Thank you so much, Dove the Dead, for having us. We're big fans, and it really means a lot to be a part
Girl
of
walks
this.
Home alone at night.
If any
have
of the stuff
that?
I talked about sounds yeah. interesting,
Good
please
movie.
Stop on our Asobu Discord.
I want to know more about
or any
walk.
Of our events
yeah.
to check out and say hi. On our website, asobu.dev, we're launching a community profile section where both foreign and domestic creators and collaborators
like
can
Northwest.
Use to find each other.
Oh, that's
and please keep an eye on our next Asobu Indie Showcase coming this September. Hope to see you there.
On its surface,
lake.
Our next game
lake.
Is a serene
yes.
slice
you,
of life
lake.
Fishing
I hope
RPG
we get a lake
in a tranquil setting, 1980s Canada.
Yeah,
underneath the waves,
work,
there lies
chat.
Exciting adventure, exploration,
Never been to Canada.
And angling.
It's
Jump
nice.
On board and
yeah,
join us on an
nice.
Epic voyage.
Nice.
Maybe
been to Vancouver
you'll encounter
and Montreal,
the mystical
and
monsters of Moonglow.
Hi, I'm Zach, creative director.
And I'm Lou, art director.
And we're the co-founders of Bunnyhug.
With our lovely global team, we're working on our studio's debut game, Mongol
Just
Bay.
That hammock
a relaxing
yeah.
slice of life fishing RPG based
slice
on a town
of
people
life.
Afraid to fish.
Slice of life fishing RPG.
Of people afraid to fish.
Oh. There's a lot going on here.
Uh-oh.
Well,
in
Guppy,
the fishing
you did it.
Yeah.
Your first
this music,
catch.
Dude. This is death music.
40 years.
That's Adam
still
Jensen.
Surprise me.
Deus Ex, never forget.
I know this place seems strange. A fishing town
yeah,
afraid
yeah,
to
it
fish.
It sounds exactly like it.
But that's why our new venture might just stay afloat. Because all those stories about the mystical monsters of Moonglow are exactly that. Stories.
Emotional.
Moonglow Bay is set along
the
coast.
Someone's
not
going
back.
During the 1980s.
Innocent fishing trip.
Yep.
Set in the 80s. Disaster.
We've always admired fishing in games like Harvest Moon and Legend of the River King. However, it's very rare to see that feature as a core mechanic, let alone in an RPG.
Yeah. Yeah, it does feel like tourist.
So, we've really wanted to capture the magic of fishing in these games and
I'm
make it the heart of our game.
I love fishing in games.
Wait.
This is six.
Here we go. Love it. World's most difficult stirring mini.
You'll be able to sell a variety of recipes. Upgrade
so
your shop.
Good right now. So anything good. Sounds good. I'm so hungry.
Rebuilding the economy of a town on the verge of bankruptcy.
I don't think any of us have had any food, and it's 100 degrees in here.
Yep.
Loving it. 10 out of 10.
E3, dude. E3 is
the
back.
E3, yeah. E3 lifestyle.
Today, hell we're excited to review the aquarium.
Yo!
It's game, dude.
This is where you can donate, preserve, and exhibit your fish while being rewarded for your efforts.
The
your journey is split into five story arcs with a fully inhabited town to traverse, and the potential for grand encounters.
Documenting over 100 varied aquatic species, all while uncovering the secrets of Munglo Bay. We're also excited to share that in addition to Xbox consoles, Game Pass and Steam, Munglo Bay will be coming to Epic Game Store, which you
it's
can
certainly short.
Tantalized.
This bay is full of amazing new creatures waiting to be discovered. So we'll find them and share them with the world. Together.
For sure.
As long as this book is by your side.
He didn't make it.
He
does not make it. That's your dad's boat.
Yeah. So am I.
Why? Why every game? Why every game?
Game Pass.
Sick.
You love to see it.
Love that Game Pass. Oh, it looks like Xbox.
This next one mashes up a bunch of genres in an unexpected way, but it's oh so satisfying. It's called Elder? Blue River, and it's from a studio called Straka out of Slovakia. And they've taken super frenzied roguelike action, procedural dungeon generation, and even a bit of Tetris, and mushed it all together in a pretty fucking cool way.
Whoa!
Hello everyone, I'm Miro from Straka Studio. Imagine if Diablo and Tetris had a baby. We're working on an island-shifting action roguelike coming to Xbox and PC, Loot River.
Oh, cool.
Yep.
Okay, yeah. Speaking our language.
The Plague Doctor mask would never die.
Yeah.
Hey,
In Loot River, we wanted to create a game about poker player agents.
Yeah, looks cool.
You're a poker player?
With the ability to rearrange the world. You can overcome even the strongest foes.
Is that what he said?
With each death, you wake up in an alternative reality. We are right now in the hub area that you can fill with useful NPCs as you progress.
Hyperlight Drifter also had an influence in a decent number of these games. Then.
The hub directly connects to the sunken village. You traverse the area using wooden platforms that you can slide in any direction you want. The platforms themselves are a handy tool in combat, dodging the fast enemy attacks, splitting groups of enemies, or providing a hasty retreat.
That's cool.
Here, we have a chest I'd like to loot. However, these guys in group would tear me to shreds. Instead, I'll make a path for them, lure them out, circle back, and get my reward.
Very cool!
You can parry most of the enemy attacks, and after, you can counterattack. Enemies get stranger as you fight your way through Loot River. Like a mage that can lock platforms together, preventing you from escaping until you defeat him.
That's very cool.
Awesome.
The level design is procedural, with handcrafted elements, similar to Dead Cells or Spelunky. This way, we ensure the levels feel intentional and logical, with a clear way forward, while also keeping every run different.
Indie devs are just like
during
saying,
your journey you'll encounter like, many
yeah, like
other,
these other games that you like.
Some of them hostile, but many still friendly. You'll encounter merchants or aspiring artists.
Mm-hmm.
Or perhaps vendors who can join your group and help you unlock permanent upgrades.
Ooh. Love that.
You'll encounter beings so powerful, your entire existence is merely a small annoyance for them.
Oh, awesome. Grabs it.
Noted.
Superhot presents.
Yeah, weird.
So I love when a game has an art style that looks unlike anything else. That's definitely the case with this next game.
So
from a
many
small
of
team in
yeah,
Ecuador,
like all
and really captures the sights and sounds of the place well. This is Despelote.
Hi, my name is Julian, and I'm the main developer of Despelote, alongside Sebastian Balbuena, who is in charge of the art and the music. The game is being produced by Gabe Cusillo, and Ian Berman is in charge of the sound.
Despelote.
You play as a kid, and you're sitting around in school just waiting for the day to be over because you just want to play soccer.
Ya suena la campana, vamos. Hola.
It's 2001, and Ecuador is on the verge of qualifying to the World Cup. They have never qualified to the World Cup before, so it is a pretty big deal, and everybody is anxiously awaiting the final match.
Mira, wow, desde aquí se ve mi casa. Mira, perro, lo dejo. Mira, se ve un perrito desde acá. ¿Vamos a jugar?
The country was just coming out of this big financial crisis. The idea of qualifying just gave a lot of people a lot of hope.
Yeah, suelta la pelota, ya vamos a jugar.
You don't really play a soccer match, because to be honest, it's just way more fun to kick it around and annoy the people in the park.
My guy here.
This park is inspired by a lot of the parks I used to play in as a kid, like La Carolina in Quito. It is full of characters just going about their day. We recorded these conversations in an improvisational manner.
No, ¿a quién le paso?
Ya van a ver, con esto queda pepa.
We really wanted to capture this community of people, and we thought that having them improvise instead of us telling them what to say just felt way more natural. They all react to the ball in unique ways, and sometimes this leads to a big narrative moment. Sebastian is doing an incredible job hand-drawing all the characters and modeling a city from pictures, from real pictures, from places in Quito.
Con la comidita que les doy ahora, ustedes también van a hacer fuerza y van a apoyar a Ecuador y mañana vamos a clasificar al mundial.
Basically, Despelote is a story about how soccer can impact a place and its culture. Thank you. I hope you enjoy it when we finally release it. Goodbye.
We have one last surprise. It's from developer Variable State, best known for their game Virginia. But with Last Stop, they evolved their narrative pedigree
game.
And take it into a much more supernatural territory. It's published by Annapurna Interactive, and that's worth mentioning because they've also been so kind to lend us a sneak peek at their upcoming Annapurna Interactive showcase, which is chock full of freeze frame moments, so you won't want to blink.
Virginia's cool. When you play it, it like cuts, like a movie cuts at random times. Like you'll be walking and then it'll cut and you'll be like in the room. It's so cool.
Yes, back here!
Don't stop!
We need to move. Whoa. Let's get him inside, out of sight.
Are you a human being? Like me?
Come a little closer. You two were made for each other.
I just want my body back.
So I feel like I haven't properly explained this. Are you okay traveling to the other side of the galaxy?
Huh? I read the brief.
We're making history here, Mina. Resources, technology, culture. This is the next frontier. I'm counting on you.
All right, I'll get the job done.
Dad!
This is not your fault. If it's anyone's, it's mine.
I think I've made a terrible mistake.
If you want my help, you only have to ask.
I gave up everything!
Come on, Hughes, this is it. Don't you want to know what's on the other side?
Yeah. It's like Contact meets Life is Strange.
There's a lot going on.
That's really soon.
That's
nice,
soon.
Dude. Yes. I'm playing that instantly.
Is it Stray? No. Psychonauts?
Maybe.
No, I think
just
it's
an
just
outro.
A closing montage. Yeah. Or it's just showing up the animation showcase.
What? Yeah, yeah. Yes. July 29th.
E3 Part 2.
Yo, that looked like Outer Wilds. That's Outer Wilds.
Yeah, this game looks...
I feel like Outer Wilds is getting something.
Well, they've said it's getting a DLC.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
July 29th!
Nice.
And that's it. Thank you for joining us for Summer Games Fest.
Super chill.
Day of the Devs Developer
My phone
showcase.
Is so warm.
See what I mean? Aren't you excited now to go make games or play games?
Those are all great.
Or to build a tree fort or something?
Like, yeah,
and I do
want
to make games.
Thank you to all the developers who submitted their games.
If you're looking to submit one of your awesome games for a future Day of the Devs, head on over to dayofthedevs.com and sign up for our email list. It's the first place we spill the beans on call for submissions, no matter what time of year it is.
Thanks to all of my co-hosts. Thanks to IM8Bit and everybody who helped with the show.
Thank you, as always, for the generous support from our partners for making all of this possible. We could have not done this without you. PlayStation, IDEA Xbox, Nintendo, Prime Gaming, and Steam. For the last 9 years, you've been on our court, and we super appreciate it. Extra special thanks to all the musicians who performed or lent their flavor to this broadcast.
Go ahead,
man. More exciting and
thrilling. I'm loving this.
We got Luca and Omniboy for We Are OFK. We got the incomparable Darren Korb and Ashley Barrett for yet again performing at Day of the Devs. This time for a supergiant masterpiece, Hades. We got the poet, the legend, Dose One, who lent us his beats yet again. to round out the editorial.
They did fix it at no cost to us. But it didn't stay fixed.
Until next time, I hope we can see that.
So maybe
we might
can
take matters into our own hands. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, scientific.
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 Dude,
Oxenfree 2?
Mm-hmm. Oxenfree hype.
Yes.
I think it's just to chill out.
Yeah, they're just chilling with the music.
I guess.
Elden Ring. That thing, you like, you're searching the frequency.
Yeah, Elden Ring. Elden Ring, Damian.
He probably explained what was about to happen. We just don't listen to any human being talk.
It's like one more spread.
Yeah, he just said now scientific.
Yeah, it's just music.
Okay.
Scientific's probably.
Elden Ring, please.
Okay. One sec.
8K.
8K, baby.
40,000
240p.
240p.
Sweat it out.
Sweat it out.
You'll walk, man.
You can jump in a pool.
Yeah.
So I feel like.
Dude, jumping in a pool sounds amazing right now. Cue it up.
Full screen. And Walker.
That's been watched.
Watched. Full watch time.
That's been watched.
Do you want audio with this, or do you just want to watch?
Yeah. Pipe it in. Wow, it was 2 minutes and 58 seconds. It felt like 30 seconds and also 20 minutes of content.
Here we
go. It was packed. It was definitely packed.
Peggy 16.
Mm. Wait, Peggy 16?
Yes.
Is that teen for us or M for us?
In between.
Yeah. Yeah, FromSoft game that's teen, that would be weird.
Not remember, actually.
The Tarnished will soon return.
I want to turn all the studio lights
that's
out.
That's the beginning of the game.
Guided by grace.
For sure.
Yeah.
Once lost.
For sure.
Open field game design.
The Golden Order
Damn.
Is broken.
Man.
Open world souls. So much to explore.
Yeah.
Looks like the Forlorn Knights. Love that FromSoft, like, hair physics. Mm-hmm. Like, weird feather fur stuff.
That mountain animation.
Oh, this trailer
looks very
so Jones.
Much better, too. He's into that.
Foul Tarnished. In search of the Elden Ring.
Yeah, the little guy.
Yeah.
I just can't get over, like, the best enemy design.
Blade of ambition. Someone must extinguish thy flame.
I'm just thinking, like, I'm gonna die so many times.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Oh,
they will fight.
Smile every time.
Yep.
And they will die.
Boom!
Yo, necromancy.
Yep.
This, oh my god, this is so high.
When he catches it, dude.
Yeah, dude. Shit.
He's a champion.
Oh, that's
cool. I love her. She's amazing.
Yeah, she's so good.
Well.
This is my favorite line.
A lowly tarnished. Playing as a lord.
Jesus.
I command
is what
thee.
We're calling. Goes places.
Fast forward, please, to January 21st, 2022.
It's crazy we're getting the game of the year in January.
I know.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, it's been a wild like year. We're gonna review Elden Ring and then we're just gonna shut down Easy Allies for the rest of the year. See you next January.
Run it back. Anything? Anything stand out to anyone specifically?
Everything?
Yeah.
I don't know. This is just speculation. But
that's what we're here for. Rampant speculation.
I feel like your style changes will just alter how you fight in a really, really cool way. Like, I love that idea of, like, being, like, having a character class and being able to change it and just being like completely different where it's like, oh my God, I have like the way that I move feels different.
I mean, just the scope, man, of this world.
Yeah.
Is like going to be so different. Like just having a mount changes things so
crazy.
Much.
Mm-hmm.
And that's going to be the biggest thing. And like, I don't want to know anything going into this world.
Yep.
Like just every hill that you climb, there's a new surprise.
Like, are you just gonna be able to run up on guys like that out in the middle of nowhere?
I don't know.
They show so many interiors. It's almost like the inverse of open world games, where the interiors are the star, and then like the open, you know,
I feel like so many
open worlds focus on outdoors. I've heard it described that it's more like an open field, which is like Zelda 1 or whatever, where it's like you have this big open thing, and then you go off on these little offshoots.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, makes sense.
Which, I mean, like, I don't know how else From Software would do an open world game.
But I can't wait to talk to you guys, and it's like, we all do different offshoots, you know? Like,
right.
Universe, yeah, or whatever.
You go into a cave, I go into a castle, you know, whatever it ends up being.
Wonder how they balance the difficulty
like,
for that.
You go to 4-1 once.
I think you're that
first,
wolf man. Like,
yeah,
I think you can
you
be
can
that
be
wolf man.
Could be just an enemy, but you can be it, maybe, yeah. Would have surprised me.
Yeah.
I mean, you can be a dragon face in the other one.
It looked like the mount was
boss,
flying.
Dude,
yeah,
shit.
It's crazy.
Another
she's amazing.
Wolf beast.
Lowly tarnished, playing at a lord. It's so sick. So we've got a Bloodborne-esque castle, a prosthetic limb. Like, is it literally all of the lores combined?
Like,
yeah.
It really
I totally get where you're coming from with that. I'm stylistically,
like,
I'm getting Dark Souls 3,
I
feel like, is what it's most similar to.
Was
that a self-attack? It might have been. Go back. Can we go back really quick?
Sure.
Look at
that. Could have been.
That guy is so cool.
Covenant.
Sorry, where do you
Covenant
want to go to?
Sure.
Right when he's attacking these people, right before this. Could
Looks
be
like
a backstab or
he's
sneaking.
Yeah, you're sneaking.
Yep.
Yes.
Good call. Oh, wait, it didn't look like an actual stealth attack,
yeah.
though.
No, yeah.
That looked like a normal one.
Looked like a classic,
like...
Like
an R2.
Yeah.
Got it.
Classic
got
backstab.
It. Got it.
But it did look like you're sneaking.
Yeah.
Which is interesting.
If you have sneak, that'd be nuts. I guess you kind of have to in an open world, right?
If there are, like...
Those masks that they're wearing
are so
more
cool. classes, I guess?
Well, wait, look, no. Go back to the deer boss.
Deer boss.
Because it looked like you had, like, two claws for hands. Yeah, right here. And then pause it as soon as it goes white.
Yeah, you got like two.
Look at
that's
that.
A weapon. Those are in the other games too. The like claw.
That looks so cool though.
Yeah. And look at your weird hat.
Yeah.
Like, and there are a bunch of little deer everywhere. That's crazy.
And then he has the deer in the later shot. This is probably how you get your mount. You're like taming it.
Oh.
Covenant
good
for
call.
Sure. Covenant for
Covenant,
sure.
Yeah. Definite Covenant vibes.
These guys are amazing. Look at these.
There's
two.
Always.
This
kind of
also has
like
strong
a maiden and a knight.
Kanehurst for sure. This feels like Bloodborne.
Yeah.
This person losing their mind.
For sure, like, crazy. Yeah.
This enemy freaks
bunch
me
of
the
rings
fuck out.
And hands.
So freaky, dude.
Spider hands.
It's like the hands from 3 Hubert, but they're just like enhanced.
Enhanced.
Look at that shield.
Yeah, big tower shield.
Yeah.
That is horrifying. Like, don't look at me, shield.
Jeez.
Don't look at me.
Look at that shit.
That's interesting that it's almost like you transform.
Yeah.
Remember that was the biggest rumor for
Bloodborne?
Bloodborne? Yeah. Oh my gosh.
That looks like character
creator. Manos, yeah. Dude, hands. Mm-hmm. Oh, you think this is the character creator?
You're like born, yeah. Right?
Right after this, you probably get grabbed and pulled in. Yeah, you're probably right. Is that how you get tarnished? Gonna devour the Vati Vidya on this.
They keep saying New World, you know, Miyazaki made the lore, all this.
And girl.
Are we 100% convinced there's no tricks being played? This is a new IP, New World here?
I think so.
I mean, yeah, but when they've said that, they've done it, right? Like Bloodborne,
yeah.
Sekiro.
Yeah.
There's no reason to.
They commit to it.
Yeah. But I mean, like, a tree running through the center of everything, like, very Dark Souls.
Yeah. Just
like,
elements of it all.
Well, it's supposed to be like Angel Soul, maybe?
Yeah, it does look like that. Yeah, it does look like that.
This guy's got axes and a Birkin arm.
Yeah.
Dude. Sign me up.
Like
he's got like
arms,
three
dude?
Axes. Look at him. Like, right side of him.
It looks perfect.
Yeah, perfect.
Everything about it is amazing.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
And you're searching for the Elden Ring, but then they're use the Elden
Brandish
Ring?
Brandish the Elden.
You want the synopsis stuff they gave out?
Yes.
Yeah. Sure.
Oh,
press
my
release.
God.
Let's hear it.
All right.
Got the codes blown?
Yeah, dude.
Marika's offspring, demigods all, claim the shards of the Elden Ring known as the Great Runes, and the mad taint of their newfound strength triggered a war, the Shattering.
Dude, I love a mad taint.
Yo.
Love a mad taint.
A war that meant abandonment by the greater will. And now the guidance of grace will be brought to the tarnished who were spurned by the grace of gold and exiled from the lands between. Ye dead who yet live, your grace long lost, follow the path to the lands between beyond the foggy sea to stand before the Elden Ring and become the Elden Lord.
That is the most From Software summary
I've
ever heard.
I don't know any of that fucking
It is almost a parody.
Yeah. I guarantee that's what Gurm wrote. And then he was just like, all right, see ya. All right, see ya. And they're like, all right, we can work with that.
What a day.
I am so excited.
They say, traverse the breathtaking world on foot or horseback, mm-hmm. alone or online with other players, fully immerse yourself in the grassy plains, suffocating swamps, spiraling mountains, foreboding castles and other sites of grandeur on a scale never seen before in a From Software title.
Wait, alone or with other people? I know there we saw Phantoms.
Yeah, it's probably
I'm
like
sure
that.
It's the same.
It's probably
yeah.
like that.
Yeah, we gotta.
But
we
can summon
full
each other.
We need multiple
sure.
codes.
Yeah.
We need to team up. This is for the review. Damn it.
We need eight codes.
We need eight codes. Two apiece.
Seriously, if it's way bigger, right? Massive
codes.
Scale.
Mm-hmm.
Co-op.
Apparently,
might
four
be
player
bigger.
Co-op.
Maybe. Four-player co-op?
There it is.
Up to...
the other ones always
have.
Are up to
I
four.
I don't think it's how you're thinking. I think it's still going to work like Dark Souls.
Kill a boss.
Put a sign down, you summon someone. Maybe you could have four people max.
I doubt this is going to happen,
maybe
but
not.
With the more open nature, I would love to just like have sort of like impromptu PvP where it's like, okay, we control this hill. This is our hill.
Yes.
No one is taking this hill.
Yes.
Anything else, or should we cool off and eat something?
We should
and
definitely
then prepare
cool off and
for
eat
the podcast.
Cool.
Definitely
quick
cool
shout
off
out
and
to Metal Slug Tactics.
Yeah,
easily
yeah.
the
yeah.
runner.
Wait, wait,
to
wait
runner
open
up.
Things up, man.
Yeah,
give
two
me a
sides
date.
Of the spectrum.
Give me a date.
Give me a date.
Yeah,
that was so. Dream
I
come
feel
true.
Very
yeah.
happy.
Yeah.
Dream
come true.
I feel
content.
So good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's been a good first day of E3.
Can you imagine how
solid all around? I think.
Dude, the
I think it's just
because
it's so hot in here.
Yeah.
I feel like the middle kind of dragged a little bit.
Oh, for sure.
Of yeah. Of Keeley's, there was a lack of new. There was a lack of excitement. I felt like for a little bit there. I don't know if that was just because of us, because of the heat.
This is.
But it felt like we were just kind of just chilling. But it was never boring because it's all just
yeah.
all the games looked cool.
Yeah.
You know?
This is actually true though. I was definitely dying from heat not that long ago, and then we started watching Elden Ring, and I feel like I'm
yeah.
actually
revitalized,
quenching my thirst.
Yep. Yep.
Oh, god damn it.
It's so hot. But but they look so hot.
Look at that.
Golden by the flame of
Can you imagine, like, seeing a castle in a Souls game?
I think we're all
going
to need to review this simultaneously.
And just going like, hey, I'm going to go there right now. Mm-hmm. And then you just try.
One of my favorite moments is in 3, the reverse of that. When you get up and you look back.
Oh, yeah.
So cool.
You're like,
that
I can't
weapon,
do
that? Dude, that moveset.
I know.
Damn.
It's so fucking sick.
That werewolf gives me Artorias vibes, bro.
Yeah, he does seem like Artorias.
Jones is pumped.
Look at that fucking dragon, dude.
Dude, just take it to the next level with that lightning.
Oh my god.
Yeah. The lightning through the dragon is the sickest shit, dude. So cool.
I love early From trailers because I'm always like, ooh, are these like cool playable characters, or are these like you or something? And
yeah,
then they're like always bosses.
Yeah, every damn time, yeah.
It's like, oh yeah, she's just a boss. All right.
Firehead.
That guy's so funny to me. Yeah.
Woo, that castle.
Yeah, it looks so good. These weird freakazoids.
It's like a, what is that? Like a lightsaber? Oh.
That, did you even kneeling that, like a covenant?
Yeah, oh, for
I will
sure
kneel to
covenant.
Her. I will kneel. Bow down. Get me in there.
Oh, it just feels good to finally see it.
Yeah, I know.
For all those years.
I never watched any of the leaks or anything.
Dude, and they blew their load here. I mean, this looks
amazing.
This
is a big trailer.
Big trailer. Birkin for sure, dude. That guy's a freakazoid. Yeah.
Keely begged.
He begged.
Yeah.
He was like,
please get me
out
of jail.
Did you see the reverence that he showed
he
at the end?
He was so happy.
Can you imagine?
Thank you.
Can you imagine if he had led up to something that wasn't Elden Ring that?
He
would have been in Game of Prison forever.
Yeah.
It's like
no one would have forgiven him.
Fucking like DayZ update or something.
Yeah.
Like, he gets put in all these games now. He only would have been in prison games. Like,
right,
prison, architect
prison architect
with Keelys.
All of them are little Keelys. Yeah. All right, well, we have to get ready to shoot the podcast.
What time? I don't even know what time it is.
But
what day is it? What time is it?
It's 2:17.
I'll throw up this schedule.
Yeah, Damiani, throw that schedule up. We've got a lot of good stuff coming up.
Today was day zero.
Today is
basically
day zero. Day one for us is Saturday.
Yes.
We're dark tomorrow.
This is the prologue.
Saturday, 9 a.m. PST. We're doing the pre-show.
Wake me up when Capcom happens.
And then, and then it's Ubisoft. Wait, what are we doing for those 2 hours?
Just dicking around.
Ubisoft, Devolver, and Gearbox on Saturday. Sunday, we've got 8:25 a.m. pre-show. And then Xbox, Bethesda at 10. Square Enix at 12 PST. Warner Bros. At 2. PC Gaming at 2:30. We'll see what happens there. Future at 4.
Sorry.
You
all right?
Monday, 7:45 a.m. pre-show. Woof.
Maybe they're on that one.
What are you doing?
Blood and Jones
Blood
are
Jones
on that
one.
Yeah, Blood and Jones can get on the desk for that one. then it's Take Two, Indie Showcase,
Suit
and
up.
Capcom. That is Capcom. And then Nintendo Tuesday at 9 a.m. We'll have a pre-show at 7:45 a.m. again. It's going to be nuts. We're back, baby.
Dude, I don't even know our schedule. I'm taking it day by day.
Yeah. Day by day, minute by minute. Elden Ring is real. Elden Ring is real, dude.
Yeah. Thank you all so much. Thank you to the mods. Thank you to Damiani and Blood and
chill, mods.
Jones in the other room, who you probably have seen intermittent snatches of. We'll be back Saturday.
And make sure to watch our
betting
special.
That's a good betting
as well
special.
As the puppet spectacular.
Yes.
It is spectacular.
I think I just took a commanding lead in our little betting special.
I think you gotta be in the lead now.
Yeah.
Long and it's loud. And
I know, right? Everyone made such crazy bets.
Dude, anything could happen.
Final Fantasy and Starfield, I think, are the next.
They're going to
megatons.
Megatons.
I got a lot of money on Halo.
Halo.
Project Triangle Strategy.
That's so fitting.
Plan your heart. All right, everyone. Thank you so much. We will see you for more E3 on Saturday. See you there. Bye.